or the Google Play Store.
We are 1580 The Fanatic, your new home for sports.
NASCAR Championship Weekend returns to Phoenix Raceway November 5th through the 7th.
A wild season of unexpected will culminate in Phoenix with drivers putting it all on the line for their shot
at earning the title of NASCAR Cup Series Champion.
Featuring four championship races in 3 days.
Don't miss your chance to witness history from atop the grandstands as the action goes five wide into the iconic dogleg.
Or from up close with access to the fan-friendly infield experience.
Get your tickets to see the NASCAR Championship in person.
Go to PhoenixRaceway.com.
Hurry, tickets won't last much longer.
Last summer, Arizona experienced record heat. Hottest summer in Arizona history. 145 days of 100-plus degrees, 53 days of over 110. Summer heat is starting sooner, and it's lasting longer, and your power bills are more expensive every year. Take control of your power bills. Call Harmon Solar today. Harmon Solar is locally owned and operated. They use top-of-the-line equipment, and they're A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau. Call Harmon Solar, 800-281-3189, or go to harmonsolar.com. Harmon Solar is an REC-certified solar professional.
Hi, this is Bruce Jacobs. My friends and former employers at ProCopy for over 20 years. ProCopy has provided Arizona companies with the best office equipment available from companies like Rico. More importantly, they provide outstanding service after the sale with a 96% retention ratio and award-winning technicians. 3 years ago, they joined the Flex Technologies Group, an Arizona-based nationwide group of companies that share ProCopy's commitment to excellence. So if you have branches anywhere in the United States or just here in Arizona, you can get great personalized service even during the current climate. We use them here at the Fanatic and Money Radio KFNN, and they never disappoint because they remain a local company. They give back to our community by supporting ASU and the Thunderbirds through the Phoenix Open. The ProCopy Foundations has raised hundreds of thousands of dollars that makes doing business with ProCopy good for your business. Just give them a call at 602-PROCOPY. That's 602-776-2679.
This is Dale Hellestray from my friends at Constructors Bonding. If you need bonds, you can put your trust in Arizona's industry leader for the best service, rates, terms, and capacity anywhere. Constructors Bonding is the number one rider with 14 sureties and will improve your bond program. Call Dave McKee today to learn how Constructors Bonding will perform for you. 602-432-5929. That's 602-432-5929. Or visit CBIAlliance.com.
WKQFN Tempe, also transmitting on K25CD Phoenix at 99.3 FM.
And K24 Bravo Hills at 95.9 FM.
People settle down
because it's time
for what?
Showtime.
When does it start?
Right now. 3, 2, 1.
Let's get on with the show.
Let's do it.
All right, everybody. It's Friday here on the Daily Blender. I'm your good friend, your radio pal, Jeffrey O'Brien, alongside Randy White. We got Phil there in the Harmon Solar Studios in Scottsdale. And we got you guys on the SupMail Medical text line, 888-368-1580. And Randy, why are you holding the stopwatch?
We're on the clock right now.
We're on the clock for what?
We're on the clock right now. It's Friday version of the Daily Blender, and we're on the clock. Let's see if we can make this the fastest show ever. Let's do it.
Oh, I see. On the clock to the weekend.
Yep. We're on the clock.
All right.
See? Well, there it is.
We can't speed up 3 hours.
There's an issue
with quantum mechanics on that. I don't know if Bruce Jacobs has had the conversation with people on the morning show yet, but I had a conversation with him about quantum mechanics, and he seemed very confused by it and said he was going to ask his listeners. But I just got to tell you, I can't help but troll people. Jeff Bloom just sent over a picture of his vaccination card. He's very proud of it. And Jeff Bloom is a host at our station in Palm Springs. He says, look, the dome is vaccinated. And I said, well, that's nice, but Moderna is the one that causes sexual dysfunction. You should have got Pfizer.
Boy. Yeah.
I just
now he's going to be wringing his hands all night.
Well, he sent back whatever, but you know he'll be looking that up later. And that's what I love. He
probably is right now.
Speaking of getting trolled on vaccination stuff, the Bills GM, Brandon Bean, he got a little call from the NFL. Hey, Brandon. Hi. Yeah, listen, the thing you said about dropping players because they won't get vaccinated. You can't do that.
Oh no.
Yeah. Can't release a player solely due to vaccination status.
Yeah.
Of course he's like, really? Well, I wouldn't do that. I would only do that because they were slow or not tall enough.
Right.
You know, something
right.
like that.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, if he, you know, he's going to say what he's going to say, and he's going to do what he's going to do. And all he has to do is, of course, if he has a slew of people who don't get vaccinated, be the ones dropped off the team.
Yeah.
And, well, it'll be pretty obvious he's lying. So whatever, the NFL has said, yeah, don't do that. Don't do that to people. 888-368-1580. Mr. Pringle is on the line. Says, happy Friday, boys. And you too, Phil. I'm buying around for the fourth dimension, Randy. So anybody ask for any booze, it's on my tab.
Okay, will do. We'll set them right up.
Navy Brad says, happy Friday, guys. Have an awesome show. Thanks, Navy Brad. You were aware yesterday that Classic Rock Thursday was your day. We played your songs. You do know that, right?
Because yeah, I think don't he
remember,
does.
I didn't remember him ever saying much except for to defend Pat Benatar as a classic rock song.
As well he should have.
And he lost that conversation immediately.
No. Heroist Pat Benatar.
No.
Heroist? You realize it's not how you say that. You say heroine.
Well, I don't do that, Jeffrey. But
did you just say Pat Benatar is hairless? What the hell happened to her?
He did not have eyebrows, if I remember correctly. Navy Brad says, yes, I do. Thank you. Pat Benatar still rocks. Okay.
Just the Tip is in the jukebox today.
That's right. It's Just the Tip's day. He won a Classic Rock Friday day. And so every song we play today will be Just the Tip's pickings. And now Randy has already previewed them. Are we in for some good stuff, or do we have to have a conversation with him about his choices?
Well, I mean, he's gone. He's out there for a reach with a ZZ Top tune. You'll be hearing that. He's got a Stones tune you don't often hear, but
deep
it's pretty
cuts.
Good.
I respect that.
And so deep cuts. And then he's got a little Petty, some Van Halen. Yeah, I think it's chocked full of good stuff, I believe.
All right, looking forward to that. King of Kitten says, double crown on the rocks on Mr. Pringle, please. That's right. He's paying. By the way, last night I was locked in Mortal Kombat. Against a Scorpion. Yep, I was out there, and I didn't even see it. A little girl, she goes, oh, there's a Scorpion. I'm like, and I turn around. There it is, standing right in the middle of the kitchen floor, all its pinchers up, like this. You want to fight? Let's do this.
Come at me, bro. At me.
And this one was usually we see them because we take care of the pest control at the house, man. We get people come out and they scorch earth outside.
Yeah.
So usually by the time a scorpion gets inside, they're groggy as hell.
Yeah.
But this one was ready to fight and throw down immediately. His stinger tail is straight up in the air like this.
Oh,
his arms
boy.
Are like this. And he's just like, oh yeah, bring it. And he sat there. So I said, I kept my eyes on the scorpion. I said, little girl, go get the lint brush.
Oh boy. Yeah.
And she's like, no, you've got a shoe on, step on it. Nick, no, watch this. And so she ran and got the lint brush. And so I took the lint brush and I got close because, you know, it could run away, run at me, or could happen.
Yeah.
And I went, bop, and it didn't stick.
Oh, like, boy.
Did it? Ah! I was like, oh, you
know. Did it at least kill it?
And what happened was a bop. It was still kind of moving around. I'm like, bop, bop, bop. And I'm like, oh, somebody has used this recently.
And
the sticky wouldn't stick, right? So now I'm stuck with it. So I beat it to death with a thing.
There you go.
And then I grabbed the paper plate off the counter there and put it on top of it. Went bam, bam, bam. So I had to beat it to death. Usually, lint brush is a perfect weapon. So, but it was helpful for disposal because as soon as I beat it to death, I peeled off some of the lint brush and stuck it to it just like that. No muss, no fuss. Took it outside. And here's the tip. When you peel the lint brush paper off with the scorpion stuck to it, as soon as you have it free, fold it in half. That way it's double stuck to the side of the scorpion. You don't accidentally touch the stinger and get stuck.
I have a question. Yes, Randy White, chief meteorologist, 1580 Fanatic.
Go ahead.
What happens if you inadvertently stick the scorpion over the peely edge of the peely paper? What happens then?
What do you mean? Like the stinger is kind of hanging out like that?
No, you grab an edge of the paper to peel it off, correct?
There's always two sides.
You pull it
from the other. There's a top corner and a bottom corner. So if it's in that wrong area, you go to the bottom. Right. Usually it's going to end up being on the top side, so you go to the bottom corner.
Have you ever
killed scorpions this way? I'm telling you, it's brilliant.
No, I can't say I have, but I'm intrigued to use it in the future.
Yeah, make sure it's good and sticky.
Yeah.
I usually
because then it's just you're just pop, 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 pop. And by the way, the reason I came up with this idea, I'm sure I'm not the only person, but the reason I came up with the lint brush idea was the I learned early on when you take a and try to smash a scorpion, if it's on carpet, you're not even hurting it. You're sitting there hitting it with something. It doesn't care. So I was like, how am I going to get this damn scorpion when it's running around in the carpet? And that was my solution. Aha, lint brush. Boink, got him. Got him just like that.
Yep. Yep.
So yeah, there was some screaming at my house last night, and not even the good kind. Boogie says, I still say you should have caught the scorpion and not killed it, Jeffrey. Yeah, because Boogie said also on the Twitter, he said, you should have put the scorpion in a jar and then occasionally threw bugs in it. And it's like having your own gladiator arena, and you are the king of your own universe.
Okay. I tell you what, Boogie, you should just go ahead and do that.
Well, he's single. I'm married. I can't get away with that. If I were a single man, I would be tempted to make a scorpion gladiator arena. But yeah, I mean, I can't do that now. Baker's Cocky Hens. Yes, I know. It's a sad story. Rest in peace to Jake Ellinger, the brother of the new Colts quarterback, Sam Ellinger. Still no word on how he passed away. It just came out of nowhere. But the Colts stuck Sam on a plane, sent him home. They're doing what they can to, you know, what can you do just to help console? Yeah. But that's his brother and him played on the same team there in Texas, which was a dream come true for the both of them. And I'm sure that stories will come out later. But that's a sad, sad story right there. Fish Tank says, speaking of Mortal Kombat, that new movie, not worth watching. Yeah, not going to win any awards, but still entertaining enough. Well, wait, you're saying two things, okay. Fish Tank.
All right.
You said it's, he said it is worth watching. Oh, I thought he said it's not worth watching. So I saw the word not, and that got me. So do see Mortal Kombat. Don't expect to see it get an Oscar.
Oh, yeah, no, there's not a lot of quality there. If you want
to saw
nice,
it?
Yeah, I saw it. It's got a nice, palate cleanser after Oscar award season, having watched a lot of those. It's certainly a palate cleanser, a lot of brutality, a lot of what have you, but other than that, it was fun. It was quality.
So of all the Mortal Kombat movies, this is the best one or the worst?
I am partial to the first one. I am very partial to the first one. The second one was just, we don't talk about it. It wasn't that good in any way, shape, or form. This last one was brutal. If you want to see like eyeballs pop out, that didn't happen, but like on that level of disgusting, it gets there. It is brutal.
Let me ask you a question. So is this eventually going to have a Street Fighter and then Mortal Kombat,
crossover
versus each other movie? Maybe.
Maybe. I'm not sure who right now owns the rights to Street Fighter.
Right.
Pretty sure Tom Cruise does.
Yeah. If I don't hear Hadouken, then I don't even care. Yep. And Hadouken is a part of Street Fighter, not Mortal Kombat, right?
Right. They are two separate entities, two separate franchises.
Yeah. Wake me when I can get me some Hadouken. That's what all I care about.
Okay.
Jagdog says, I scoop the scorpion up in a cup and I drown it in alcohol, or I blowtorch him in the rocks. Well, okay, I can't do that in my kitchen. Yeah. And why would I waste whiskey that way? Yeah, Phil's absolutely right.
Yeah.
King of Kittens says, hey, I just got my first shot of Pfizer. Listen, once you get that second shot, your Wi-Fi is going to be amazing.
Mm-hmm.
Navy Brad says, since I had one not so good tune, you're not going to ban me any events.
No,
ban you from events.
No,
I'm just gonna rag on you for that one. We played the song, Navy Brad. We love you. Mr. Pringle says, WTF is a palate cleanser. Sons, hey, I want a palate cleanser. I have a glass of wine. Wait, what are you? Now palate cleanser is an appropriate term. I'm not gonna give him a hard time. You know, when you eat something, you're like, that's a bad taste in my mouth. Then you eat or drink something else to cleanse the palate. Or if you're sampling, say, any whiskeys, beers, or wine, you know, go to those places, hey, there's a flight of beer. I'm like, you just gave me seven beers. Thank you. Well, there'll be certain things in between they'll say you should do for a palate cleanser, so you can appreciate and taste each one of those beers, whiskeys, or wines as it was supposed to be. So Phil's not out of line for using that term.
Yeah, there's certain palate cleansers. Whenever you go and you get colognes or perfumes or whatever, that's why they've got those coffee beans around.
Right.
Palate
right.
cleanser.
Phil is out of line for a lot of crap he says, but no, not palate cleanser. Last Optimist says, am I going to need my vaccination card to show up at remotes? Nope. Well, there's no way we would do that. We suggest it. We hope you would. We want you to be safe. I mean, yeah, I don't want people showing up to something and being risky with themselves. But yeah, that's your thing. And we're not going to do remotes until we feel like it's a statistically safe thing to do. Jagdog says, I use my wife's White Claw, not my booze. Yeah, you know, soak that thing in alcohol.
There you go. Is that alcohol, though? White Claw?
No, there's not much in it, is there?
No.
Eddie V says, speaking of wine, Aaron Rodgers, if he leaves Green Bay, what are they going to do with all that cheese and not having any wine left? not bad, Eddie V. Good question. We're going to talk about Aaron Rodgers here in just a little bit. I have what I thought was going to be exciting news, and it's turned into not as exciting news.
Okay.
These showed up last night, if you can see that. The Manstitution of the United States right here in my hand actually turned out pretty nice. It printed up real nice. It's not a big document, but it's like any other pocket constitution. It has everything in there that you need.
And what size font is that? Like half?
Well, I'm surprised you can read it.
No, well, I'm not holding it up to the camera, right? So
yeah.
I like that. You can read it. I'm not going to lie. It was kind of small. Well, guess what? That's the good news. I got these back from the printer. The bad news is there's a problem.
It's in Spanish.
Yes, it's absolutely in Spanish. De donde la este es el hermano, el donde se llama umbrella es en el hermano. I don't know Spanish, Phil, so I can't even do that.
I see.
It's actually in English, but it reads like Spanish.
Ah.
James, a man shall not rub the area of his arm that has been punched. If the area is rubbed? A man needs to be punched again in the same area twice.
Yes.
No, sir.
Why does it sound much more sensual?
Let me, well, I can't help it. That's just the way I sound when I speak Spanish.
Unseen in a thousand suns.
Let me show you something. So here's why these aren't going to work. First, there's one little misprint in this thing. My wife found it pretty much immediately. But the other thing was, when I gave it to my wife, to edit, well, not really edit, but for her to kind of proofread, make sure I didn't make any huge grammatical errors, that stuff. She's very good at what she does. We had the feature on that gives you corrections, like where she shows me where she's made a correction. And it has a little notation. Well, there was a glitch and it wasn't caught, not by me, not by the printers, but you can still see on the page. See that gray line right there?
Oh, yeah.
That is where one of them had been. And those are sort of scattered throughout this this document.
Oh,
so
boy.
Here's the thing that's going to happen. I'm out the money because we're not selling these. I'll give these away as little things previous for the listeners.
Yeah.
It's all the same content. But what we're going to do, we're going to reprint. And we're going to make the font bigger. So because I even looked at it, I was like, even with my glasses on, yeah, that's a little small.
Yeah,
it's readable, but still. So we're going to make it bigger, more pages. Going to fix that one little weirdness and take care of that thing. So these we'll just give away to people, as gifts. But then the ones that we'll sell for charity, those will be the nice, good quality ones. So anyway, so it's good news, like, yay. So I kind of blew it. I did. It cost me
money. Well, it's not your fault. The printers should have caught that. Somebody should have caught it.
I should have caught it. What happened was I turned that off. And so when I actually saved it to a PDF and I sent it to the printer, it had been removed. But unbeknownst to me, you have to save it as a completely other document. And there's some other things that had to be ticked off so they wouldn't show up again. So what happened was I didn't see that, saved it, it converted the document, and it came back. And that's my fault. It's all my fault. And it's not the charity's money. It's my money because, donation, I guess, to help out. So, but at least, hey, we will always have these little copies that we can give to people.
We'll
I'm
always
not gonna
have
make
Paris.
Anybody yeah, pay for stuff that ain't quite right. So but we'll take care of that. Now I'm going to get torched. I know. Deflated Balls says, dude, I'm a printer. Didn't you look at the proof? Yeah, I did. I did. I, you know, I sent them the thing. They sent it back. Mm. I looked at it, and I just, in the first few pages, as I kind of look, I'm like, yep, that looks good. That looks good. I didn't look at every single page, and it's more than a few pages in before those gray marks start showing up. That's my fault. It's absolutely my fault. I take full credit. King of Kitten says, White Claw is actually 5% alcohol. Still, not manly. Moist One says, nice and small to match the size of your ego. Thank you. Boogie says, gives me a comforting sense of security knowing that Jeffrey doesn't know how to print photos properly. This isn't about photos. What are you talking about? This is just a... This was supposed to be for charity. I feel like a failure. I feel like a failure that I screwed this up.
Nah,
seriously.
Don't do that.
But that also means that these will come out as little add-ons and prizes and stuff that we'll give people, you know, down the road. So I'm a little bummed out about that, but I'll get over it. At least I'm not the Lakers. Oh, that makes me happy. I'm not the Lakers. Hey, Phil, remember you said there is no way they'd have to be in a play-in tournament? And then remember later when you said there's no way they would miss the playoffs? Are you still confident that there's no way they'll miss the playoffs? I mean, are we mathematically still okay for them to get into the play-in?
Yeah. They'd have to get to, like, number 11. There's no way that they won't make it into the play-in game. Outside, the only thing that now worries me is this back spasm issue with Anthony Davis that he left. That was far more important than the loss that they suffered. It is worrisome about these injuries. And outside of that, if they can make it in and face anybody of note, I feel like we'll be fine. But that is
we're going to talk about that a lot more when we come back.
Oh, are we?
Oh, boy. That's right. Oh, yes, man. The Clippers making my dreams come true. The Lakers looking more and more like a play-in team that won't even survive that. Come on back, kids. It's the Daily Blender here on 1580, The Fanatic.
For the ones who get going when the going gets tough. And the ones who know we're tougher together. For the pathfinders breaking new ground. Grainger offers supplies and solutions for every industry, as well as fast access to experts and 24/7 customer support. Because we know you have people depending on you, so you can always depend on us. Call, clickgrainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
This is Aaron Warby, owner of Online Trading Academy here in Arizona. Right now, we're seeing stock market highs in the face of economic lows. Election cycles are notorious for causing instability in the stock market. That's why we just finished developing our newest complimentary workshop, Protection from the Election. This three-hour class will explore the strategies professional traders use to protect themselves against market downturns while allowing them to also profit from surging markets. Take control of your portfolio in these uncertain times. Register for this powerful workshop offered in Scottsdale, Chandler, and Peoria by calling 844-877-2337 or by texting the letters OTA to 31996. Space is limited and all COVID safety measures will be followed. Again, that is 844-877-2337 or text OTA to 31996.
Last year, the series' most popular driver took home the championship.
This season,
it's anybody's guess who will win. We celebrate Mother's Day at the Lady in Black, Darlington. Throwback weekend, 11:30 a.m. Sunday morning.
Don't miss a moment of the ground-pounding excitement of NASCAR.
Sponsored by Phoenix Raceway.
And your new epicenter for NASCAR racing in the Valley. 1580 and 99.3.
The Fanatic.
Last summer, Arizona experienced record heat. Hottest summer in Arizona history. 145 days of 100-plus degrees, 53 days of over 110. Summer heat is starting sooner, and it's lasting longer, and your power bills are more expensive every year. Take control of your power bills. Call Harmon Solar today. Harmon Solar is locally owned and operated. They use top-of-the-line equipment, and they're A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau. Call Harmon Solar, 800-281-3189, or go to harmonsolar.com. Harmon Solar is an REC-certified solar professional.
The Tampa Bay Bucks! Super Bowl 55.
Super Bowl 55 is in the history books, but we are kicking up our feet and waiting. The 2021 season has begun.
and there's already been a lot of action.
Because the NFL never takes a nap.
Free agency, pro days, hirings and firings, the draft, training camp, and more.
We will keep you in the know with all the news, insights, and analysis.
Football is always in season here.
Your exclusive home for the NFL and Super Bowl 56.
1580 and 99.3.
The Fanatic.
Took a while to get here.
What? I like that. What is that?
I like that. That's James Gang Funk 49.
Oh, yeah, we got to get some more of that. Classic. I really like that. Nicely done, just the tip. It's the Daily Blender here on 1580, The Fanatic. Have a little classic rock Friday. The songs chosen by you guys, the super fans. Today is Just the Tips Day, so looking forward to hearing the next ones. And before we went to break, we were so rudely interrupted and ushered along by old Father Time and Phil's constipated look on his face. We were talking about how... how the Clippers have helped, make the Lakers even more likely to have to play in a play-in tournament. Now, I'm sorry. I feel bad if AD is actually legitimately hurt. It would seem like he probably is. But I'm going to say this right now. I am sympathetic to the injuries. Absolutely. I don't ever, even in jest, I don't like to joke about wanting somebody to ever get hurt. Aaron Rodgers with his his chopsticks called clavicles, the ones that just snap so easily.
His maracas known as clavicles.
Right, we're not asking or hoping that happens to him, but it's a thing we joke about after the fact, and when once he's okay. So when it comes to AD or even LeBron, I wish no ill on anybody, but in this situation, kind of glad the Lakers aren't going to make it. Not glad why. I'm just glad they're not. And I don't see them surviving a play-in game now.
What do you mean not going to make it?
You're not going to make it, man. AD is hurt. LeBron is hobbled. LeBron, I don't know if I'll ever be fully recovered. Yeah. If that is a legit injury, I will, I'll feel bad. And yes, you are correct, Phil. That will be the explanation of why the Lakers failed this year. But if in that play-in game, suddenly LeBron is there and suddenly AD is there and they're playing hero ball like nothing ever happened, I am calling B as in B, S as in S on the whole thing, and I'm going to be quite angry about it.
Well, they are going to try to step up and play if they make the play-in game, which I still don't know that they're out of the playoffs and into the play-in game yet. I don't know that that's clinched, but if they get there, you know that LeBron and AD are going to do whatever they can to try to play in that game.
There's a difference between do whatever you can, try to make an effort, and then somebody flipped the switch and suddenly here come the heroes. And they're like, nothing was ever wrong. I'm serious. LeBron has in the past, there is documented video proof, forgotten which leg he was supposed to limp on. It's a real thing. So so if that happens on the play-in game, that's just that ain't right. That ain't right at all. And I will never forgive that. So are they mathematically in a place where they're likely to be play-in, Phil, or are they still surviving in the regular playoffs statistically?
No, right now they're in a tie with Portland at 37-29. They play this Friday. They play today. And that will determine who is the sixth and who is the seventh seed. Right now the Lakers have the tiebreaker and hold the sixth seed, which doesn't mean that they would be in the play-in game or play-in tournament. So let's see after tonight. Let's see after tonight.
If the Lakers lose it all and the Trailblazers win it all, Lakers are playing in.
Yes. Well, I mean, there's
now
also
we know how to root. Now we know how to root.
Right? Are we rooting for Dame Time? Is that what we're doing?
That's right. Damian Lillard, you weirdo, you go out there and you get yours.
You weirdo. Why is he a weirdo?
He's always just kind of struck me as weird.
No, dude,
he's a little strange. I like him. I think he's great, except for when he's playing your team. You know what I mean? But I like him. He's just kind of weird to me. 888-368-1580. Big Steve says the winner of Lakers Portland tonight actually is what gets the season tiebreaker. Yeah, I think Phil said that. That's, right?
Yep.
Got it. Baker's Cocky Hen says, if the Lakers finish ninth or 10th, will they forfeit? Or will LeBron be the fake ass he is and still play? I mean, he said they should fire the person who came up with this. So why should he be able to participate? Because he was the one calling for it from the beginning. Talk about a man card violation.
Yeah, that's true.
Bruno Baller says, the James Gang featuring Joe Walsh, of course.
Yes, absolutely.
Mr. Pringle says AD is a first team all pro quitter. Just ask the Pelicans fans.
He didn't quit on them.
Yeah, I haven't seen that he's a quitter. He's been
injury prone. I'll give you that.
Yeah, he's pretty fragile. But other than that, I don't know that he's a quitter. I've seen him play some spectacular ball, but he is very fragile.
And even last year, we saw him play through a lot of injuries that a lot of people felt like in the past he would have sat through. He wouldn't have pushed through. That was one thing that they were lauding and applauding LeBron James and the mentality that he was bringing to Anthony Davis, saying, oh, my goodness, look at how he's responding to being in a championship run. He's somebody who is blossoming under the tutelage of LeBron James and saying, tough it out. I mean, this is what needs to happen whenever you're in a championship contending window.
So when you get tutled, you will be lauded and applauded. Is that correct?
You can tattoo that on your behind. That's how good of a lesson that is.
Yeah, that sounds like a t-shirt right there. When you've been tootled, you'll be lauded and applauded.
Yeah.
Why are you putting the boner sound on that? I don't understand that.
You've been tootled? Are you kidding me?
Have
you been tootled?
No,
I mean, when I get tootled. Tutored.
I should have said tutored, but it tootled.
Not
like somebody's got tootled right there.
Yeah, little tootling going on here.
Really not what I was going for there, but all right. 888-368-1580. And Prison Wallet says, at a sushi bar, ginger is actually a power cleanser, not to be eaten with the sushi. I think he meant palate cleanser, and you are correct.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see here. Fairweather Dan says, blame it on the scotch. I don't know what he's talking about, but I agree. Large Marge says, how ironic this show would print something with typos. After all these messed up texts you get.
It's not typos. It was a call out.
Yeah.
No, it was one of those call outs.
No, it was tracking changes. And the document itself is good. So that's why I don't mind giving these away. It's just going to have these annoying little lines sometimes next to part of the text. The only little mess up was mine, because I had to type this one out directly into a graphic for some reason. And it says, my comment was this: a real man is never threatened by another person's sexuality. If you use this document to be homophobic or misogynistic, you will be absolutely got it all wrong, and your man card will definitely be permanently revoked. There was just one B too many on that.
Yeah.
They should have just said it will definitely be revoked, be definitely be. So that was it. Yeah. And I can live with that. But those little lines, I was like, the hell with it. We'll have to reprint this. So, oh, well. Jagdog says, will the Lakers even win another game this season, Jeffrey? Is my camera blurry?
It is a little blurry.
This is what you all look like to me when I don't have glasses on. I'm looking at the computer.
Let's see. The Lakers have Portland at Portland. I definitely think that's a winnable game versus Phoenix. Phoenix, I don't know much more what they'll be playing for here, but let's see. New York, Houston, that's a dub. Indiana, that's to be determined, which I'm sure they'll play. And then New Orleans, that's another to be determined. I'm sure they'll
lose. All they do is lose.
They've got a three-game winning streak to end the season. If they decide Phoenix and New York, they might lose.
Sorry, I wasn't listening to you. I was just enjoying the All They Do Is Lose song.
Oh, you're talking about the Suns?
Yeah, clearly the number one team in the country. Sure, go ahead.
Did they get routed by the Trailblazers?
Routed?
Yeah, or to
why do you play the boner noise for that one, Randy?
Routed.
He wasn't talking
about being tootled.
Yeah, tootled.
Being routed sounds a lot more icky than tootled.
I don't think
Being routed?
No.
See, that doesn't sound right.
No.
He was routed. He was routed. No, see, that didn't work.
So I brought her to my place and I routed the hell out of her.
No.
I guess I can make anything
see,
sound.
See, that doesn't sound, no, that sounds creepy, is what that sounds.
It does. Moist, speaking of creepy, Moist one says, hey guys, I know this is a long shot, but I'm having a housewarming party tonight. Yeah. Love for you guys to show up. Oh. And I could even get the missus to grill up some steaks. Wait, darn first it. Off, when did you get a missus? That's new. I never knew you had a missus. I thought you were a single lonely man. Kyle G says, a miracle, guys. I'm done with work early on a Friday. Time to go home and make some fried chicken for the wife and kids. Randy, pour me a whiskey. Let's do this thing.
Where you are, my friend. Yeah.
I've got to remind my wife, honey, if you're listening, we need a bunch of thighs, chicken. And a bunch of legs, chicken. And I want to, this weekend, make the fried fries chicken. I want to try it. Believe me, I knew the minute I said that aloud, I had to tag on chicken or else Phil. Phil would have been standing on my front porch.
Randy, the man needs more thighs.
Circumcised Mosquito says,
let's go
not sure how you're using toodle in a sense, but I need to take a toodle right now.
Hey.
Okay, that's not what that means. Ooh, that is not what that means, Circumcised Mosquito. So I guess Phil's not having any of it. We wanted to razz Phil about the Clippers putting the smack down on the Lakers.
I'm not worried. It doesn't matter. They're still in the playoffs. Let's go, baby. It doesn't matter.
Yeah, let's go, baby. We'll have at least one game left.
We'll have one game left of like Phoenix Lakers. Is that what you're
You'll
talking
have
about?
No games left after your first game in the play-in.
I don't believe it.
I'm willing to bet.
You're willing to bet?
I guess we'll do a beer bet or something on that. I don't know.
Well, let's see where we're
what
at.
Do you want a Jamba Juice? I don't know how you roll,
Actually,
Phil.
I would love a Jamba Juice. With all those add-ins. Oh,
okay.
I love it.
So, well, what's a comparable thing in alcohol to a Jamba Juice?
It's pretty similar. I mean, just get like a Coors.
Oh, I know. Yeah. No. Irish Car Bomb for me. Jamba Juice for you.
All right.
Wow. You know what an Irish Car Bomb is?
No idea.
Look that up. It's not an actual car bomb. It's a beer which you drop a whiskey shot into. You'll see. Take a look at that. Boogie says, Alexa, I also need a bunch of thighs and breasts and legs for my house tonight. Please order some and have them delivered to my house. I greatly appreciate it. Thank you. Okay, first off, I don't call my wife Alexa. You guys all do. I call her something else. Second, she's not ordering anything for you. Go get your own woman. 888-368-1580.
Number one result, is it offensive to order an Irish car bomb?
Why would it be?
The term car bomb combines reference to its bomb shot style as well as the noted car bombings of Ireland's troubles.
Just look up the damn drink. We don't need a civics lesson on this one. I'm Irish, so I'm telling you it's okay to say.
The name is considered offensive by many Irish people.
Wow.
With some bartenders refusing to serve it.
Oh, brother. Okay. So note to self, don't say it if you're in Ireland in the wrong neighborhoods. Okay. But in general, it's fine. Jeff the Tip says, good afternoon, gentlemen. Thank you for allowing me a chance to provide the bumper music on Classic Rock Friday. I might have reached a little bit there, yes, with the ZZ Top tune, but it's their first official hit on the Billboard charts.
Yeah.
Well, we're really enjoying it, Jeff the Tip, so good job so far. Randy, he says, may I please have one Evan Williams neat for every song I suggested that doesn't suck, so when you play it, please also pour me a drink when you guys come back.
Well, then we're one behind. There you go.
Yeah. So far, one for one. It's hard to beat some Joel Walsh, isn't it? All right. Navy Brad, we're not allowed to lock people into cupboards or closets or bathrooms. So, no, Phil will not be locked anywhere. Although I've been
in the closet for too long. Once I'm out, I'm out.
Yeah, you have us all fooled.
Oh, boy.
So one time, though, I did, you know, how do I put this, Randy? There was a guy I used to fart up the studio before Randy I would get there in the mornings.
Yeah.
And so one day he was in a literal records closet where there are boxes with the actual vinyl records. So I backed in and then I closed the door and held it so he couldn't get out. I hot boxed him in the record room and he's like pounding, let me out. And I'm like, you get what you got it coming. And then he told the program director was like, no, that's actually fair.
Yeah.
That's actually fair. You had it coming. You're going to sit there and stink up and fart up the FM music studio. Well, by God, you get what you get. I don't think he ever did that again, though, did he?
No, I don't think he did. He made sure and had some sort of disinfectant spray, and he wore that. He wore that spray out right there in the studio.
Tell you what, these days, though, yeah, I'd have been fired. I would have been, it would have been a news story or something.
Yeah.
Fish Tank says, now we have to say, can I get a shot of half Irish whiskey, half Bailey's and a Guinness? That's an awful lot, Obama. Mr. Pringle says, Randy, what's my tab at about now? I'm just curious.
It's not too bad. It's not like the last time we had a tab for you.
Friday's just getting started, though, Mr. Pringle. Whistle Hayes says, does Conor McGregor allow Irish car bums in his new bar? No, as long as you drink the proper 12, you won't get smacked in the face.
Yep, that's
true. Prison Wallet says, is it good or bad that I just don't care about people's religion or sexual orientation or insert whatever one thing into another thing? As long as my rights and freedoms aren't being infringed on, I just don't care. Prison Wallet, that's the absolute right way to look at it. You are 100% correct. Fish Tank says, thank you, thank you. Thank you. All right. So where were we? Let's see. Clippers are great. Destroyed the Lakers. Lakers in trouble. It was a huge blowout. We didn't mention that. It was a huge blowout. That was a huge blowout. Yeah.
Talking about the Suns.
What is there? For you to be like the other day, you were smirking through the entire time I talked about how the Suns got blown out. So that's what you get. Karma is working overtime on Phil and the Lakers because of Phil. This is all your fault, Phil.
I feel like I was fair with the Suns.
You have single-handedly ruined the Lakers. I'll be honest. No, Phil has, though. Phil, I mean, I believe that 100%. But Phil has been a gentleman the last few days about the Suns.
A few days. I think it's been like 2 weeks.
No, it's been a few days.
Feels like a month.
So I will stop. I'll stop piling on because it's no fun when he doesn't, when he doesn't play. So when we come back, let's talk about a team that might be playing in a new town. Does that mean we have to call them by the new town name, or do we still call them by the old name? And you'll probably be a little surprised on the team I'm talking about. It's a Daily Blender here on 1580, The Fanatic.
I need these boxes in bin 7. Oh, hello. Hi. I just wanted to call in and find out when.
Whitney's warehouse foreman just retired, and the replacement needs to move to fulfillment.
Hold on. Guys, can we get the dock cleared now?
Indeed can help her hire the people she needs.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. When you sponsor a job, you immediately get your short list of quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job criteria. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
Everybody, Mark Asher, about to tell you about my friends at Valley Medical Weight Loss. I love this company. I've used them. I have friends that have used them. A ton of weight has been lost in a quick amount of time. And the right way. That's the important part. Look, they have 3 Valley locations, Tempe, Glendale, and Phoenix. So one is close to you. And they've been doing this for well over a decade. And right now, you can get your first week, $31.95, absolutely free. Just mention Money Radio or mention The Fanatic, and it is on them. 602-441-3305 or valleymedicalweightloss.com.
Hey, guys, Jeffrey O'Brien here. Listen, when we're all working on our shows here at The Fanatic, we're totally focused and we don't want to worry about the other things, like the technology that runs our station. That's where Affinity Technology comes in. They run all our IT so we can focus on what really matters, our business and our listeners. These guys handle literally everything. If it plugs in, they work with it. They've saved us tons of money and have kept us focused on what really matters. Affinity Technology, they can do the same for you. Go to atechaz.com. Be sure and tell them I sent you.
Last year, the series' most popular driver took home the championship.
This season,
it's anybody's guess who will win.
We celebrate Mother's Day at the Lady in Black, Darlington. Throwback weekend, 11:30 a.m. Sunday morning.
Don't miss a moment of the ground pounding excitement of NASCAR.
Sponsored by Phoenix Raceway.
Your new epicenter for NASCAR racing in the Valley. 1580 and 99.3. The Fanatic.
Changing your work culture can help change an entire culture. By embracing diversity, you encourage diversity. By making accommodations, you become more accommodating. So consider a member of Arizona's Deaf, Hard of Hearing, and Deafblind community for your next hire. To learn more about the Let's Get to Work initiative, visit changeyourperception.org. That's changeyourperception.org. Sponsored by the Arizona Commission for the Deaf and the Hard of Hearing.
The Fanatic.
Today, the Blender here on 1580, the Fanatic, Arizona's new home for sports on a classic rock Friday. All right, so yes, it's a thing that's actually being talked about. When I first saw a news story about this, I thought, nah, somebody's just making noise. It's not going to become anything. But now people are talking like it might be real, might be serious, or it might be just another move by a sports team to try to get some money and renovations for an arena or for a stadium. And what I'm talking about is the Chicago Bears. There is talk that they are seriously considering a move from Soldier Field to a new place in Arlington. And so now a lot of the Chicago Bear fans are a little upset about this.
Well, I would imagine they would be. Yeah, Chicago Bear fans have been in that stadium for decades and decades. So
I didn't even say probably almost like a century. Well, I guess yeah. Soldier Field. Maybe not.
Well, they've been at Soldier Field since 1971, but seriously, that thing has been around, I think since 1924, and hasn't had any major renovations since 2003, so 18 years ago. And the other thing about it is the stadium only seats 61,500. Sounds like a lot, but due to spatial constraints, it's one of these smaller stadiums in the NFL.
It's pretty massive.
I think this might be a play to either renovate the stadium at taxpayer expense, or maybe they're serious about being called the Arlington Heights Bears.
Wow. I don't believe that. I think they would always be the Chicago Bears.
Well, you can't call yourself Chicago if you're in, by the way, I have not looked up a map. Can somebody please take a look at where Arlington is? Arlington Heights is in, is it like, say, Gilbert is to Phoenix, or is it like
I'm sure it's a suburb of the Chicago metro area. It's kind of like Irving, Texas. That's where the Dallas Cowboys play all their games, Irving, Texas, and yet they call them the Dallas Cowboys. Right. It's a suburb of Dallas. I've been by there many times in my travels.
If it is indeed that close, then okay, they can still be called the Chicago Bears. Phil, how close is Arlington Heights?
Well, it's pretty smack dab in the middle of Illinois.
That's not what I asked. How close is it to Chicago? Do you know how to read a map? Okay, well, we'll figure that out. Surprise, Bob Schursky isn't already on this. Navy Brad says, oh, I thought it was me, the Coyotes heading back to Canada. Well, we'll talk about that next year. Blissel Hayes says, why Arlington, Texas? Ooh. No, Arlington Heights, Illinois. Yes, Phil.
Arlington Heights is about an hour away, 27 miles.
You can't call yourself the Chicago Bears if you move an hour away.
You can.
Oh,
you
can. Now, come
remember
on.
The Golden State? An hour away? Listen, Glendale is an hour from my house over here in Queen Creek. Yes, all of these things are connected, but they don't call it the Phoenix Cardinals anymore, do they? They call it the Arizona Cardinals. They're not going to call them the Illinois Bears.
Here you go.
People in the South can't spell Illinois.
Arlington Heights is a municipality in Cook and Lake counties in the U.S. state of Illinois, a suburb of Chicago. It lies about 25 miles outside of the city center.
Wait, 25 miles out of the city center? How do you figure that's an hour away, Phil?
It says right now. You want me to send you a picture?
I believe you. Right now, I'm confused.
It says an hour and 3 minutes.
Well, they need to increase their damn speed limits because that sounds ridiculous.
Yeah. but keep in mind, Jeffrey, that a lot of places and teams keep some of what they do as long as they're within the same state. Look at the Golden State Warriors. They were called the Golden State Warriors, even though they were located in Oakland.
Yeah, the Golden State is California. Oakland's still part of California.
Yeah, but they had the whole thing with the bridge.
All right,
there.
Fine. We'll call them the Teamster State Bears. How's that? Because they're better. What else do you have for Chicago or wow. Illinois? What are the Land of Lincoln Bears? I mean,
can
what
they
are
be
you
the Blowy Bears?
The Blowy Bears?
Yeah, because of all the wind.
No.
Oh,
Wow. No. I thought that was some sort of perverse gummy bear. No. Hey, Blissel Hayes says, Randy, can I get a shot of a double shot of Jim Beam and put it on Pringles tab? Thanks.
Absolutely. Oh, there you
Randy
go.
Never forgets.
There
never
it is.
Forgets. Fairweather Dan says, Arlington, isn't that where Bob Newhart's office is?
No, Arlington Heights. Arlington Heights, that's not where his office was. His office was downtown Chicago. I was right by the building there in downtown Chicago. It's right off the lake.
I thought that was just a TV show.
It was.
Wow. Ookla Mock says, poop emoji, hi, Radio Pal. Whatever, Ookla. Fish Tank says, I mean, the New York Jets and Giants, yeah. They all play in New Jersey. So
yep. Los Angeles yep. Angels.
So this is going to be the thing, though. If you're the mayor of Arlington Heights and you do whatever you do, I guess you would go ahead and let them continue to be called the Chicago Bears, because you're going to get all that tax money. You're going to get all the benefit of them coming to your town. It's going to be a huge influx of finances for that community. So, yeah, I guess they wouldn't care too much what you call it, as long as they build a stadium there.
Yeah, they don't care. You can call them the Minnesota Bears for all they care, as long as they get the taxes.
Pretty sure that would cause a riot and there would be dead people if you did that.
No.
Mr. Pringle says the Chicago Bears originated in Decatur, Illinois. Decatur is approximately 4 hours south of Chicago. Well, they didn't call them the Chicago Bears when they were in Decatur, did they? I don't think so. Boogie says, all right, it's an hour and 3 minutes outside of the center of the city with traffic. Yeah, that's why. It's still part of Chicago. Wow. I don't ever want to drive there. If it takes that long to go 25 miles.
Yeah, man. You don't remember everything on like kind of the East Coast is, even though that's more centered, but it's still on the eastern side of it. But that everything's got toll booths and everything.
Yeah, when I used to stand up and I go through a town like that, I was going at different times of day and rush hour never even occurred to me. So I had no idea it was so slow there.
Oh, I know. I went through with a rental car once through one of those places, not knowing. And they had to go through the rental company. And then by the time it hit me, I had like a $500 ticket.
Yikes.
Yeah.
Kyle G says, for the Bears to change cities would be nigh unto sacrilegious. Make a new stadium in Chicago if you have to, but talk about moving them out of there, it's ridiculous. This is one of the only things this Packers fan will join in with a Bears fan over.
Get it.
Why do you care?
Well, it's a heritage franchise, Jeffrey. It's like if the Green Bay Packers were to ever move and go somewhere else, somewhere big time, if they were to go to England or something, I think that there would be a lot of outrage, because at some point you do need Staples. You do need a New York Yankees. You do need a Chicago Cubs.
There'd be an outcry if they moved to Milwaukee.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that would really anger people.
Yeah.
Right. Random Texter said, so if they became the Arlington Heights Bears, they'd get rid of the C and they put a big old H on there. I think on their helmet should be AH, like, Arlington Heights Bears.
The Bears.
Navy Brad says, so if I just heard correct, the Bears want a new stadium next to Arlington? No, they actually want it in Arlington. He says, I thought that was a huge cemetery for heroes.
That's
in Washington, Maryland. Navy Brad. We're talking about in Chicago. It's Arlington Heights. Fish Tank says, I got a vaccination in Chicago back in July. Coming soon here. I will report back in 2 months. Cool. I have no idea what that all means, but I agree. 888-368-1580. So, yeah, see, this is the cool thing about the Cardinals. That's one thing. When you got a cool state name, Arizona Cardinals, that sounds great. Illinois Bears. Not so much. Not so much.
Yeah, well, I think they would keep the moniker the Chicago Bears. It's again, it's a suburb. I don't care what they say. Just like Gilbert and Chandler is a suburb of Phoenix. It would be
disgusting would that be? The Gilbert Cardinals? Oh.
Well, what's wrong with Gilbert? Hey, except for it's like got a bunch of damn racist kids running all over the place. What's wrong with Gilbert otherwise? And jackass police officers who are really kind of uncool. What's wrong with Gilbert?
What on earth could possibly be wrong besides these two fundamentally horrible things about Gilbert?
Yeah, there's two fundamentally horrible things, but I went to junior high and high school there for a little bit of high school in Gilbert.
Yeah.
And you made it out relatively unscathed.
It wasn't bad back then. We didn't have all them racists, and the cops are still jerks. But I'm just saying. Blissel Hay says it's very rude to build a football stadium in a cemetery. All right, you people, for the last time, it's not Arlington Cemetery. This is nowhere near the District of Columbia. This is
in Illinois. So just saying. All right, I don't want to talk about this anymore. You people are stupid. Oh, I got some booze news for everybody.
Booze news
for you. If you like cheap beer, but you like classy cheap beer, oh, here's something for you guys. Miller High Life is running a contest to hire a, quote, ambassador of the Champagne of Beers region. What is the Champagne of Beers region? Well, they're actually trying to get the city of Milwaukee to create a region in honor of their beer, and they need somebody to promote it. So you can apply for the job with a 50-word essay on why you'd be a good ambassador, and then if they pick you, you'll get $20,000 a year and a bunch of free Miller High Life. And the applications are due 2 weeks from the day. The thing about this is, has to be a part-time job, and nobody can exist on $20,000 a year, even with the free Miller High Life. So I don't think you'd be expected to, you know, move and do this, you know, full time.
Yeah, I see your point there.
I'd say go to the Miller High Life website for full details on that. So, yeah. This is probably something good for a student. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah.
Like a part-time gig or something.
Yeah, something to supplement your income.
Yeah. By the way, science, because I guess AIDS has been cured and COVID has been cured and cancer has been cured and heart disease has been cured. Science has come out with this. A study in France has found that a pint of beer, how much bubbles do you think are in a pint of beer? If you were to sit down and count the bubbles in a pint of beer, Randy, how many bubbles?
10 million.
Phil, what do you say?
63. Remember,
just 63 bubbles.
Just 63.
What's really sad about this is Price is Right rules. Phil has won because, Randy, you've gone over. I'm sorry.
Damn it.
10 million was high. 63 is low. They actually counted them 4 million bubbles. There's 4 million bubbles in a pint of your beer, and that's how many the beer can kick out before it actually goes flat. So,
wow,
I'd say you drink that beer before it even gets to a million.
That's absolutely
the way to do it.
Yep, that's the way it's done.
63, Phil.
Listen, maybe they're lonely. Maybe they like to mingle, and then they procreate in the beer. So therefore, originally, there's only 63.
There will be no procreation going on in my beer from this point on and forevermore.
Well, I mean, you could consider the fermentation of the.
Yeah.
No, I'm not going to ruin beer. I ain't going to ruin beer. Nope. I'm just going to be quiet. Yep, going to be quiet.
Drink those, and by the way, bubble babies.
Phil, the sad thing is, your answer would have been very respectable if it had meant that you had just shotgunned the beer. They'd only had time to make 63 bubbles.
Yep.
But
yep,
we all know that that's not the case, because you're sitting there sipping on your Jamba Juice. So,
absolutely.
But that's all right.
With
that's
an extra right. wheat shot.
Mm-hmm. Ugh. Why do you hate your mouth? All right. Listen, I don't have any more booze news unless anybody else does. You got any booze news?
Apparently, and I just found this out today, but apparently an Irish booze car bomb news is an offensive term.
Not to me. And I'm Irish. So don't worry about it. In America, nobody's going to be offended. So why don't you explain to everybody, now that you know what an Irish car bomb is, what exactly an Irish car bomb is?
Yes, it's a shot of cream dropped within a shot glass inside of a beer of one's choosing.
Cream?
Huh. Yeah, they said it was cream.
Okay, no, it's a shot of whiskey.
Oh.
What? I'm going to have to look this up, what you're looking at. You know, maybe a cream liqueur if you really wanted to do that. But yeah, it's not just cream. That's gross.
Well, I wasn't going to judge you on your drinking choices, Jeffrey.
That sickens me. Boogie says the Santa Clara 49ers will come to a town near you very soon.
Yep. The Santa Clara 49ers. Yep.
Large Marge says, come on, Jeffrey. We all hate Phil's mouth. It's not just him.
Oh.
Who was that? Who said that?
Boogie, see, there you go. Boogie is right. Oh, that was Large Marge.
Yeah.
Boogie, yes, Boogie gets it right. It's an Irish car bomb, half shot of Jameson, half shot of Bailey's, dropped in the Guinness.
Okay. I'm not there saying you're wrong. I just think that me being wrong is a little bit.
You didn't even really read it. You just saw the word cream and got happy.
I just stuck with the cream. That's what
that didn't sound right at all. Thank you, Hefty Lefty. He's got it too. You are all correct. Random Texter says the Glendale Cardinals, they play in the NFL.
Yep.
They're not called that. They're the Arizona Cardinals.
That's why I think the Gilbert Cardinals, it just sounds wrong. Even if they were to relocate there, I think I'd be fine. But be just don't call them the Gilbert Cardinals.
Well, you could still call them the Arizona Cardinals.
Yeah.
For the Indianapolis Colts, if you wanted to give them the state designation, the Indiana Colts? I don't know. That didn't sound, just sounds weird. So when we come back, let's talk about the curious case of Aaron Rodgers and other assorted things. It's the Daily Blender here on 1580 The Fanatic.
Warning, this product contains nicotine. Nicotine is an addictive chemical. Vuse Alto is the vape as unique as the back roads you ride. With Vuse by You, you can choose from 7 colors, 3 flavors, 3 nicotine levels, and infinite wrap designs. Make Vuse Alto a vape that is yours, in store now. Discover more at Vuse.com. Vuse, charge beyond. Vapor products, underage sale prohibited. Website and offers restricted to age 21 and over tobacco consumers.
For the ones who get going when the going gets tough. And the ones who know we're tougher together. For the pathfinders breaking new ground. Grainger offers supplies and solutions for every industry, as well as fast access to experts and 24/7 customer support. Because we know you have people depending on you. So you can always depend on us. Call, click Grainger.com, or just stop by. Grainger, for the ones who get it done.
Everybody, Mark Asher, back to tell you about my friends at Valley Medical Weight Loss. I love this company. I've used them. I have friends that have used them. A ton of weight has been lost in a quick amount of time and the right way. That's the important part. Look, they have 3 Valley locations, Tempe, Glendale, and Phoenix. So one is close to you, and they've been doing this for well over a decade. And right now you can get your first week, $31.95, absolutely free. Just mention Money Radio or mention The Fanatic, and it is on them. 602-441-3305 or valleymedicalweightloss.com.
Thank goodness it seems like the worst is over, but is your business back to pre-COVID numbers? Hi, Bruce Jacobs here to invite you to take advantage of a great opportunity to promote that you are open and ready to serve with our affordable Open for Business advertising package. You'll only spend hundreds, but reach thousands of potential new customers. Just go to 1580thefanatic.com and click on the link for Open for Business package. This offer will not last long. The Open for Business package on 1580 The Fanatic. Now let's all get back to business.
Our beautiful daughter Ashley was only 12 years old when a distracted driver went to the light and ran into our van. When an email comes over your phone or a phone call or voicemail, it's not worth it.
Life is more important than your phone's beep. Stop the distracted driving, Arizona, please. Sponsored by the Arizona Chapter National Safety Council and the Governor's Office of Highway Safety, aired in cooperation with the Arizona Broadcasters Association and this station.
Contractors need bonds, and the professionals at Constructors Bonding have been Arizona's leading surety management team for 40 years. We don't just deliver bonds, we make your bonding better. As the number one producer with 14 markets, Constructors Bonding has the relationships and expertise to get you better capacity, better rates, and better terms. For better bonding, call Dave McKee at Constructors Bonding at 602-432-5929. That's 602-432-5929. Or visit cbialliance.com.
KQFN Tempe, also transmitting on K25CD Phoenix at 99.3 FM
and K240U Fountain Hills at 95.9 FM.
Right, people, settle down.
Because it's time.
Time for what?
Showtime.
When does it start?
Right now. 3, 2, 1.
Let's get on with the show.
Let's do it.
All right, buddy, it's 4 o'clock here on the Daily Blender, and good friend, radio pal, Jeffrey O'Brien, alongside Randy White, get Phil there in the Harmon Solar Studios in Scottsdale. You guys are in the Summit Mail Medical text line, 888-368-1580. He's just a little worried about something.
What's that, Jeffco?
We may need a weather report here in a second, because my wife, she just sent me a message. The first thing she said was, chicken and recipe ingredients for you to make fried chicken at home have been ordered. So, yes, okay. She was listening earlier when I asked that, and
very good.
She said, this better be good.
And you needed more thighs, right?
Oh, I love thighs. And then the next thing was, she says, but for Mother's Day, I would still love to have some steak, please. And I says, honey, I will be happy to grill that for you.
Yeah.
And then she says, thank you. And she says, but you know, it's going to be hot. I'm like, really? How hot? She said, it's going to be 1,011,110 degrees, though.
Sounds scientific.
It says that right there on her text, as you can see, as I hold that up to the phone there.
I see that.
It's a little blurry, but my camera's kind of bad right now. So, can I get an actual weather forecast? I don't ever want to contradict my wife, but that seems a little hot.
Absolutely, Jeffco. Sunshine, word of the day, 93s for the highs through the weekend, 95 Sunday, Monday, 93. Back up to triple digits next week. Sunshine throughout the days. Mild evening, 63, 64, 65, something like that, overnight lows. Currently outside, 97 degrees in downtown Phoenix. 97 degrees in Scottsdale from the 1580, the Fanatic Weather Center. Chief Meteorologist Randy White, back to you, Jeffco.
Well, that's a relief. I'm glad it's not going to be 1 million degrees on Sunday. That was a concern. I love my wife, but
95. Yeah.
Shows you how awesome she is, though. You know, that's what she wants for Mother's Day. She wants some steak. Ah, good lady.
Nothing wrong with that.
Boomer Sooner says, hey, Jeffrey, just received an email from Arizona Sports Angels thanking for the donation. It says, thank you, actually, to Alexa. By the way, how's your weight loss going? Please beer me, Randy. Well, I haven't weighed myself since earlier in the week, but I got to tell you, it's not been hard at all. You know, the hardest thing for me to do, I guess I got into a weird routine where I keep forgetting to take my vitamins. So that's going to slow down my progress, because in those vitamins, I got some metabolism boosters, stuff like that. And without that, I wonder if I'm not just hurting myself, you know. I've got to get better at remembering to take my vitamins and my supplements. But you know, the other things that they recommend, dietary ideas, exercise ideas. And one of the big keys, and Radio Ron agrees on this one, drinking lots and lots of water.
Yep.
Can't stress that enough. Drinking the 10 glasses of 8 ounces a day, 8 ounces, 10 times a day. It seems like a lot, but it's only 8 ounces. Your glass is generally going to be like 16 ounces if you got one of those big tumblers or something. So
right.
Just try to get yourself about 80 ounces of water a day, and you'll be in good shape. And you'll say, well, the human body doesn't need. No, shush. You're trying to lose weight. Make the effort. You know, you're going to have more frequent trips to the restroom. But guess what else that does? Gives you a little mini burst of exercise, doesn't it? You have to get up. You have to go in there. You got to walk around. So, I'm reading stuff about exercise. And they gave me this nifty booklet here, The Weight Is Over, when I first went there. And I've been sticking to this pretty carefully, reading up on stuff. They've got information about how bad the soda can be for you. They have information on just the different ways of doing things, some great advice, a lot of great tips and stuff here. So I don't think I've gained any weight, but because I've sort of just, my brain is just poof, on remembering to take my vitamins. I don't know. I'll probably weigh myself after the show, but I did take my vitamins today, so I'm feeling pretty good. So
well, there you go, Jeffco. Way to be back on track there.
I'll get you guys a full report on what's going on with me next week, when I plan on going down there and saying hi to our friends at Valley Medical Weight Loss. Now, listen, like I said, everybody is going to have a different way of doing things, you know, based on, you know, how much money you want to spend on the weight loss. Also, just based on what works for you, what's right for you. And they will help you through this. They're not trying to pressure you. They're not trying to sell you. When I went down there, it was just, hey, what do you want to have happen here? What is your goal? What do you want? Here's how we can help you do that. Whatever it works for you. That's the most important part. Finding something that works for you. And when you find something that works for you, you will stick to it. So if you're looking to lose some weight, you can't go wrong. Contact Valley Medical Weight Loss. Go to their website, valleymedicalweightloss.com. And there's 3 convenient Valley locations. You don't even need an appointment. You just carve out a little time for yourself some morning and go on over there, sign up, sign in, and they'll get you together with a person that'll help you start, and then they'll have a conversation with the doctor, and you're good to go. It's very easy. So go to valleymedicalweightloss.com. I'm
very
still
well
sadly,
done, Joko.
I'm still so sadly overweight that I'm now out of breath from talking about valleymedicalweightloss.com.
Oh, please. Yeah. Yeah, you're just so heavy and overweight. Yeah, yeah, I could see that. Well, rolls of fat all over you, Jeffco. I can see that. Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you. That was kind of hurtful and mean, Randy. What the hell?
Well, it's the truth that you don't have anything on you. You look amazing.
I've got a spare tire. My spare tire is a full size spare.
You want to talk a spare tire? I've got a damn 18-wheeler spare tire right here around my midsection.
Listen, everything is relative. To me right now, this is the biggest I've ever been in my life. And seeing how things have worked for you and Mark Asher and James and some other people at the radio station, I finally says, yeah, I got to get this going. So that's why I'm doing what I'm doing. To me, it's still an unhealthy amount of weight that I'm carrying. I may carry it well. It's not as noticeable, but oh, God, it's noticeable to me. When I'm walking, that is a horrible gauntlet of low self-esteem. When you leave the radio station and you walk through where all those reflections are of all the windows, and you go through that gate, and every time I look over, I'm like, who's that fat bastard? Oh, it's me. Oh, God, who's that puffy face? Look, oh, God, it's me again.
Yeah.
So, yeah, you may be a little bigger than me, but still, what I've got is enough to give me cardiac problems someday. This is enough to be a health concern, and I don't want to have to buy a bunch of new clothes. So, yeah, it maybe seems like, no big deal for you. But it is a big deal for me, just like it's a big deal for you. So I don't mean to, sound silly, but I got to lose this weight. Have you met my
good
wife?
For you.
She's beautiful. My wife is beautiful. Eventually, she'll leave me. She will
I
leave
highly,
me.
Highly doubt that.
She'll find some guy that is like all slim like Phil, and it's over.
I don't think so. She's Alexa. She is madly in love with you, Jeffco. Yep.
You better be lucky I'm working from home today, or I'd be this right there in your Friday. Kisser. You bastard. Boomer Sooner says, what the heck is Phil doing in the control room? Well, he'd be locking himself in there right now if I was there. He'd hit on my wife right here on live radio. Did you hear that, Randy?
I heard it. Big as life. Yep.
All this talk about weight loss made me run to your office and get some Jolly Ranchers.
Well, the Jolly Ranchers are probably less fattening than all the little chocolate bars I had in there last time.
That's fair.
Hefty Lefty says, move the Colts up the road to Carmel, Indiana. Then they could be the Carmel Colts. I wouldn't be mad at that, actually. There I love go. Carmel.
Yeah.
Screaming Eagle says, oh, my God, what a week. Glad it's Friday. Heading out. Hope you guys have a wonderful weekend. Enjoy, Mr. Screaming Eagle. Prison Wallet says, there's two different drinks. One's called the Car Bomb and one's called a Hand Grenade. Either way, it's not a beer of your choice. It's a Guinness. Get it straight, Phil.
What did I
He's
say?
He's right, you know. He is right.
Beer of your choice.
Oh, it's
you can try it with other beers, but it won't be.
He's trying to tell you use the Irish beer, the Guinness.
Right. Got it. Right. Large Marge says the Lakers are 14-21 since they were embraced by Philly the Kid there after the Suns lost to the Nets and Harden scored like 200 points. 14-21. What was their record before that? I'm not trying to be a wise ass.
They were like second in the West or first in the West.
Are you starting to feel maybe you did karmically have something to do with that?
No, I mean, outside of LeBron, if it was just LeBron James and maybe everybody else on the team getting injured, but AD, I don't feel that was already in the works. LeBron was a weird one, but that was about halfway through. No, I feel fairly confident, man. I feel very good about the Lakers still. It's not optimal, but I still feel very good.
Skull says, Jeffrey, you should move to Mars. You'll be 38% lighter.
Yeah.
I'll still look like this, though.
Mm.
Uklamok says, hey, Chubbies, you call them vitamins. Baseball players call them greenies. I'm not doing any drugs or any. Yeah. All the stuff that I've chosen to do through Valley Medical Weight Loss is pretty natural stuff. I'm not going into the other echelon of weight loss stuff. So do they
frown upon? Do they allow the fried chicken? What's the story on that?
Why don't you shut your mouth, Phil? Why don't you mind your own business and don't say nothing to nobody about the fact that I'm making fried chicken?
Ah, Phil. What
the hell's wrong with you?
I was just curious.
You're C-blocking me. You're trying to chicken block me. That ain't right. That's in the Manstitution. You don't C-block anybody. And I'm going to say the C also stands for chicken. All right. So let's talk about a guy.
All right.
Some love him. Some hate them. And
Elton
by
John?
Some, I mean me. Talking about Aaron Rodgers. And now here, more information starts to come to light, and I get more and more confused. Somebody remind me legitimately why Aaron Rodgers is so upset with the Packers that he wants to leave. Let's pretend like I've never heard the story before. Why is Aaron Rodgers so mad at the Packers he wants to leave?
Because they fired personnel that was closest to him. They have yet to draft an offensive skill player in the first round since he's been with the team. And they have been planning for his future while he still remains on the team.
Yeah, everything you just said there, you pretty much could have wrapped up into they drafted Jordan Love. Why sure. didn't you just say that? All right. So what I don't understand is in his conversations with the Packers, a lot of people have said, come on, Packers, pay the man and make it right. So he stays in Green Bay and finishes his career up there. He's playing at a level which if you guys do your draft and your free agency right, you should be winning a Super Bowl. So a lot of people started putting it on the Packers saying, the hell guy, why don't you just pay the guy? And yeah. Turns out they tried to. Apparently they offered to make him the NFL's highest paid quarterback again earlier in the offseason. And I, for the life of me, I can't figure out why that wasn't enough. And what more can the Packers do to make Aaron Rodgers happy? What is the end game for Aaron Rodgers?
Well, it's counterintuitive to pay him right now because he's been trying to, as much as any other quarterback, try to get assets on the team, physical assets on the team that he can use to help make the team really? Better, help him
so
win.
So when the free agents were calling him up and saying, hey, I'm thinking about signing this free agent deal. And he's like, hey, don't count on me being on the team when you do, because I'm probably going to be out of there. And that is a proven thing. He has told people who were mulling free agency with the Packers, whether it be from somewhere else or more so the people who are on the team, he actually was telling them, don't count on me being there. I ain't going to be there. So that is almost like tampering from the inside. You're trying to sabotage the very team you're hoping is mm-hmm. going to bring in good players to play with you.
Yeah, it seems a little childish, I think, on Aaron Rodgers' part to be holding a grudge like this. He and the second thing is he should not have broke this news. And Adam Schefter has been out now trying to clear things up, but he should not have broke this news about his imminent departure from Green Bay on draft day. So he's been catching a lot of flack about that. And I'll be honest with you, Jeffrey, I just think it's kind of immature. It's not about the money. It's about, it seems to me, it appears to me like it's all about him feeling wanted.
Well, he is wanted. The Packers have never told him that he's not wanted. And the only thing they have done wrong was draft a guy without having a conversation with him about it first. Yeah. And really, okay, maybe he has a point. And I'll tell you what may have also pushed him over the edge. It was hearing about how the Bears treated old Andy Dalton. Andy Dalton, when they decided that they were going to go ahead and do what they did in the draft, they gave a call. They gave a call and they said, hey, listen, we're not sure exactly who or what we're going to try to trade up. We're trying to get us our quarterback. I just want to let you know that. And Andy Dalton said, hey, I appreciate that. Getting that heads up and I get it. It's part of the thing and I'll be happy to compete with and be a good teammate. And so the Bears at least talked to Andy Dalton. And yeah. If Aaron Rodgers saw this story, which I'm sure he did, he'd be like, what the hell? Seriously, the Bears can do this right, but the Packers can't. And yeah. That could be part of the reason that, and he's a whiny little bitch.
Well, I'm sorry, Phil, just one quick comment and then you can shoot here. Again, I think he just does not feel respected. He does not feel wanted or needed in Green Bay. And he has been lobbying for some offensive weapons for many years. And this GM, this new GM and this new regime, just refuse to go out and get talented players. Go ahead, Phil.
It's been reported now that Adam Schefter has admitted and gone out on other stations that he was not given any breaking news the morning of the draft, nor in the few hours leading up to the draft. And so he just dropped this quote, this Woj bomb, right. Like Schefter bomb, on the eve of the draft, all on his own.
To guess what he's not telling you. And what he's not telling you is it was Aaron Rodgers or Aaron Rodgers' people who gave him this information and said, you know, because remember, he needs these connections. He does not want to burn any bridges. So if Aaron Rodgers or Aaron Rodgers' people called Schefter up and said, listen, this is what we're trying to do. We want to let the world know this, but please, we want you to do it on Thursday morning. Schefter's going to say, okay. But he's not going to admit to you that that's what happened. But I would almost guarantee, because the whole thing was timed perfectly, like some PR person or Aaron Rodgers decided, hey, this is the moment, because I want to make sure teams out there know so that my team starts getting pressure. This was perfectly timed for Aaron Rodgers. Wouldn't you agree to that? So if that's the case, Schefter waiting today played right into that. It wasn't that Schefter was like, well, I have that information, and, well, I just figured that the perfect time to do this would have been Thursday morning. Oh, not Friday, not Wednesday, but Thursday morning. Come on, Schefter, you're full of crap.
I don't think that it works out perfectly for Aaron Rodgers. I think that the news of this coming out, that there was nothing breaking, nothing new coming out that he felt obligated to report it. He just dropped it whenever he felt it.
Why not Wednesday?
I agree. I think that it looks bad on Schefter.
Why not Friday? That's why I'm saying he had an agreement with Aaron Rodgers and company. That's what I think. And I think it did play perfectly for Aaron Rodgers that got released on Thursday. Because what were we talking about all through the draft? Aaron Rodgers. And it put pressure on other teams to do other things, to try to be in a situation where something could happen.
But it still did turn the swell of the tide, at least in the minds of Green Bay Packers fans. And having that home base is always going to be important to players like that, franchise players, to have a base of somewhere where they will respect you. Even to this day, Packer fans still love Brett Favre. Some of them, even if you put them in a comparison, love Brett Favre more than Aaron Rodgers, even before all this fiasco and drama. That being said, it makes Aaron Rodgers look a lot better when you don't see that, oh, he just gave Adam Schefter the scoop, to go right there and drop it right then when Adam Schefter comes out and says, Aaron Rodgers didn't want this. The Packers organization didn't want this dropped at that time. I can assure you, I think it is taking the blame and placing it on Adam Schefter. And it takes it away from Aaron Rodgers looking quite as petty as he did initially.
Guess what? Accomplices sometimes do little jail time too. They're all guilty. All right, we got to take a break. When we come back, we got your texts on the Summit Mail medical text line and more about how Aaron, he might have messed up. Tampering charges? It's the Daily Blender here on 1580, The Fanatic.
Everybody, Mark Asher, about to tell you about my friends at Valley Medical Weight Loss. I love this company. I've used them. I have friends that have used them. A ton of weight has been lost in a quick amount of time, and the right way. That's the important part. Look, they have three Valley locations, Tempe, Glendale, and Phoenix. So one is close to you, and they've been doing this for well over a decade. And right now you can get your first week, $31.95, absolutely free. Just mention Money Radio or mention The Fanatic, and it is on them. 602-441-3305 or valleymedicalweightloss.com.
Come to Summit Mail Medical Center to take control of your love life and your health. A recent investigation of men with low testosterone showed more than half were diagnosed with depression. That's depressing. 89% of the men in that study had erectile dysfunction. 69% had a low sex drive. Now that is really depressing. But it doesn't have to be that way. Come let Summit Male Medical Center put a smile on your face and your spouse's. Call 480-398-1000 or go to summitmalemedical.com. Come see our all-male medical staff, the most experienced and knowledgeable staff that deals with ED, PE, and low T that you'll find anywhere. We've been in the Valley since 2008, and we've helped tens of thousands of guys, and indirectly their loved ones, achieve happiness with a healthier life and the newfound ability to rekindle their love life. Don't wait or hesitate. Come get a smile on your face. Get happy. Call Summit Male Medical Center, 480-398-1000, or go to summitmalemedical.com. Kiss the blues away.
Last year, the series' most popular driver took home the championship.
This season, it's anybody's guess who will win.
We celebrate Mother's Day at the Lady in Black, Darlington. Throwback weekend, 11:30 a.m. Sunday morning.
Don't miss a moment of the ground-pounding excitement of NASCAR.
Sponsored by Phoenix Raceway.
And your new epicenter for NASCAR racing in the Valley. 1580 and 99.3.
The Fanatic.
Last summer, Arizona experienced record heat. Hottest summer in Arizona history. 145 days of 100-plus degrees, 53 days of over 110. Summer heat is starting sooner and it's lasting longer, and your power bills are more expensive every year. Take control of your power bills. Call Harmon Solar today. Harmon Solar is locally owned and operated. They use top-of-the-line equipment, and they're A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau. Call Harmon Solar, 800-281-3189, or go to harmonsolar.com. Harmon Solar is an REC-certified solar professional.
It's the greatest spectacle in racing. Speed of 230 miles per hour.
200 laps, 500 miles.
Only one driver takes home the BorgWarner Trophy and gets the icy cold drink of milk in victory lane.
For 105 years, it has been a Memorial Day tradition. The Indianapolis 500. Hear it live. May 30th on your home for the Indy 500. 1580 and 99.3. The Fanatic, Arizona's new home for sports.
Daily Blender here on 1580, The Fanatic, Arizona's new home for sports, and it's Classic Rock Friday. What song is that, Randy? It sounds familiar.
That's the Stones, Lies.
Oh, okay. Yeah, it had a unique sound to it, but I'll be honest, I don't know if I've heard this song before. Thank you for that. Just the tip. It's Just the Tips Day on the Classic Rock Friday here on the Daily Blender on 1580, The Fanatic. All right, so Aaron Rodgers, you know, this whole drama, it's got to come to an end soon, right? I mean, is this going to come to an end with a retirement, or is this going to come to an end where Aaron Rodgers finally gets the Packers sign off on a very expensive contract? It looks like he's won. The Packers don't care because now they've still got their MVP quarterback. How can this thing get resolved before training camp?
Oh, before training camp, I'm not sure it's going to be done before then. I think as much as I would love it, I do think that it would be playing on another team. I'm not sure if it's the Broncos. They are the leader right now, but who knows? I am just saying, like, that is an aside.
It's your dream, but guess what? He's either going to retire or they're going to give him another contract, and that's his out to be happy.
Look, even if he does retire, remember, Aaron Rodgers, his agent, I believe it's Dunn something. I forget what his first name is, but Dunn was the agent for Carson Palmer. Carson Palmer, and he had to retire for nearly an entire season before he got his way, and before he had to take a pit stop on the Raiders before he finally ended up with the Cardinals.
There's a difference, and that's the age. Carson Palmer was a younger man when he pulled that move. Aaron Rodgers is a little bit longer in the tooth. Missing a year is not in his best interest.
But the difference is that Carson Palmer had grown up in a very different NFL. He was in a very much more physical, more get to the quarterback. That's where he spent the majority of his career. And then he benefited towards the end with all the passing yards and everything that he got there. Aaron Rodgers more so grew up in that era of the NFLs. And we've seen it. All these quarterbacks are having extended careers more so than we have seen in previous generations.
Yeah, but I don't know that you're going to extend Aaron Rodgers the same way you can extend a Tom Brady.
No.
He has taken a way more serious injuries. He's put a lot more miles on himself than Tom Brady has. But, you know, maybe I'm wrong. Maybe you're right. Maybe Aaron Rodgers will go the way of the Brady. He sits out a year, comes back, and has another good 4 or 5 years. But I'll tell you what, that is a risk. I'd say that is a risk that as an older quarterback, I'm not sure that I'd want to take. And I'm not sure that your agent would want you to do that. I think this is going to end up being a face-saving situation where when the Packers come back again and say, Aaron, come to the table. Come to the table. Let's talk this out. They'll give him whatever he wants. They'll give him whatever he wants just to stop this and come back. Or if you're right, then they're going to say, go retire. Go retire, because I really do believe the Packers come out in better shape if they do that than if they trade him.
No,
unless it's to the Seahawks, which I think would be hilarious.
No, because here's the thing, is that even if he retires, he still holds a cap number over them. And that's a very big cap number. And
it's not as big as if they trade him.
Well, immediately, but part of the reason why they're having such a tenuous situation right now is not because of the money directly. It's more so the years. Remember, they're not having any issue or problem giving Aaron Rodgers more money in the immediate future. Yes, it's at the expense of the team, but that's kind of what the whole dilemma is anyways. So whenever they're having this dilemma, Aaron Rodgers is like, no, I want to be the highest paid quarterback for the next 5 years, as opposed to the next two. What does that do for me this upcoming season and then the following season? That does nothing for me, and it just helps you guys out and get out from underneath me.
Three weeks and 3 days, guys. 3 weeks and 3 days before anything happens. Unless Green Bay can somehow land Aaron Rodgers. 3 weeks and 3 days is the target day. June 1st is the day to be watching.
And I'm why telling is that you right Randy? Now?
Because they won't take a huge cap hit if he walks away or if they trade him.
I'm telling you right now, if I were the Packers, I would just say, okay, go ahead and retire Aaron Rodgers. But before you leave, I here's your box of stuff from your locker, but let's go ahead and do you want to do credit card? Do you want a check or you Bitcoin? How do you want to give us our $29,800,000 back? How do you want to, because you got to give that back. That's not yours. That was contingent on you continuing to be a Packer. So $29 million, please, right here in my hand. Give it to me. It's mine. And Aaron Rodgers is not going to like doing that. He is not going to like doing that. That is when more reasonable heads will prevail. An agent is going, I'm sure somewhere that is already part of the plan, where Aaron Rodgers might be like, hey, agent man, this is starting to get kind of weird. What's our end game? Well, your end game is this. Aaron Rodgers, I believe, is either ready to pull the chute and be retired and pay that back. But more likely, he's just going to sign a contract with the Packers and he'll move on like nothing ever happened. That's what I think.
I really just don't see it, Jeffrey. Maybe I'm partially biased with the Broncos, but truly from everything I've seen outside of it, I do think Aaron Rodgers is that spiteful, is that petty enough to hold out and retire for a year, force the Packers' hand and have them commit to Jordan Love. Then once they have him, there's no reason why to keep Aaron Rodgers around and then be forced to trade Aaron Rodgers at some point.
Packers would not be mad at that. Can I tell you why? Because the moment that happens, you're in an automatic rebuild, which takes all the pressure off the coach and the GM. And it becomes a situation where you're like, you know what, the hell with him. You know, we couldn't quite get over the hump. Now we can build this team the way we want to, either around Aaron Love, Jordan Love, or somebody we're looking at the draft. Now I get it. Taking a look forward at the next draft, there's one quarterback. It's worth a damn. One, it's not a quarterback rich draft. I'll give you that. But at this point, they can start to work free agency. They've got more cap space to make some deals and do with the things that need to be done. So but I honestly don't think it's going to get there. I honestly do not think you're going to see Aaron Rodgers retire or be on another team next year. I really believe Packers are going to put that golden tray full of goodies in front of him again. Aaron Rodgers is going to say, well, they've done this and made me feel better about that. And we've come to an agreement. This is mutually, I've always wanted to be a Packer. I'm so glad we were able to work this out. And I'll be on the field playing for you guys next season. I really believe that's what's going to happen. Not because I care or like Aaron Rodgers. It's the smartest thing he can do. Unless, like you say, Phil, if he is that petty, that's all this is. And that is some self-destructive behavior, which is going to really screw him up, even trying to move forward. And then the other thing you wonder is, what the hell did Danica Patrick do to him?
Oh, you think that this was Danica Patrick's doing? I think he had this in him long before Danica Patrick.
Yeah, well, it wasn't until Danica, but no, it was Olivia Munn when he got estranged from his family.
Yeah.
All right, well, enough about what the Packers or Aaron Rodgers is going to do in their situation. Now, the Packers have already started looking for some other quarterbacks to bring in to sort of, whether you go with Jordan Love as your starter, or if you're bringing in another free agent to play as Jordan Love is working stuff out. I know that Blake Bortles, Nick Mullins, Robert Griffin III, Matt Barkley, they're looking for deals. And the Packers are like, well, this will suck a lot, but we got to do something. So they're just assuming that things are going to go badly, and they're having conversations with other quarterbacks. But one of the things that you have to, can you go after a guy on your own team for tampering?
It depends on if it's negative or positive.
Well, it is negative. Aaron Rodgers telling prospective Packers free agents, I probably will not be on the team next year. Before you make any decisions, he says, I'm probably not going to be there. He was telling this to more than one person, David Bakhtiari, Aaron Jones, these guys on the team, other people from other places. That was his message. Before you make any decisions, understand this. I'm probably not going to be on the team. Isn't that tampering in a way? I guess you can't go after him because he's on the team, but feels like he should be suffering some consequence for that sort of nonsense.
Yeah, I understand what you're saying, Jeffrey, but I mean, at the same time, he's also played alongside with these guys. And some of these guys, I think he holds dear as his friends, and he's probably just letting them know, you know, well, you can make your decision, do whatever you want to, but just keep this in mind. I'm not going to be here. Yeah, so if you want to stay here, it's going to be a different scenario.
Yeah, you can't punish the guy for being honest and trying. Because if he were to do the reverse, I know people have accused LeBron James of this before in the past, where he didn't tell Dwayne Wade when he was leaving Miami, and he re-upped, and so did Chris Bosh, and they were just sitting there waiting, and then he stranded him when he went back to Cleveland. Everybody understood that move, but everybody killed him for not at least giving them a heads up and letting them know, and they found out along with everybody else. Whereas in this room, Aaron Rodgers, he has to be the quarterback. He has to be the leader of everybody in that locker room, even the defensive guys. So if he can't be held to be responsible and honest with those guys, what's left for him?
All right, so I can agree with you on existing players making decisions, but what if he's telling this to people that might be possibly thinking about coming to the Packers? Now that's different, right? Now that's a jerk move, right?
No, I think it still applies. Because again, play this out to the end, I think we're all in agreement that he's not ending his career as a Packer, right?
Yeah, I feel like he's probably going to stay. Yeah.
I don't know.
Are you saying like he's going to end his career as a Packer, Jeffrey?
Yeah, I think he will. I think he will. If they make this right and they save face, it's going to be the kind of contract that he'll probably play through and finish his career.
No, there's no way. I'd be willing to bet a truckload of Jamba Juice smoothies on that. There's no way. Yeah, I may be wrong on it being this year, but he's not going to retire a Packer. Anyways, let's avert from that.
Well, I imagine he'll do that one obligatory year in the Vikings, but that'll be it.
Well, okay, sure. Even then, 1-2 years somewhere else, that still counts. But if he goes somewhere else, you never know where these free agents go. If they get traded somewhere, and one bad apple who you spurned somewhere down the road has a good point in saying, you know what, he told me to go to the Packers. I got stranded in Wisconsin, where the only thing I went for was him. And then I had to stick 3 more years around there in the frozen tundra and lose.
Cheese? Everybody loves cheese, though.
Everybody loves cheese, but not to live there. Have you been to Wisconsin?
Cheese curds and beer. That's quite the Friday night thing.
I went to Lambeau and I did a tour there in the middle of winter. They were about to play in their playoff game. And that was the coolest I've ever been in my life.
Phil, you ever had did you get any of those fried cheese curds and some of that beer?
I did. They were
damn actually, good.
They were
I'm just
going to
say.
Crazy good.
Yeah. That was the only thing that warmed me up. Otherwise, I felt cold to my bones.
All right. Well, but enough about your bone. Let's talk about Aaron Rodgers again, please. So Aaron Rodgers, I think, all right, we can't get him on tampering, but can you get the 49ers and the Broncos on tampering? Because once the rumors start floated, there are some reports that the 49ers and Broncos may have actually reached out directly to Aaron Rodgers, taking the old temperature there. And remember, any public or private statement of interest, qualified or unqualified, in another club's player that the player's agent or representative or to a member of the news media, that is a violation of the anti-tampering policy. We immediately heard people saying, oh hell yeah, we'll take Aaron Rodgers, sure thing. I mean, a lot of other people were doing that, jumping up ready to make that happen. So should the Packers be going after those teams for tampering?
Definitely the 49ers. They should leave the Broncos alone. Just kidding. No, yeah, they well, definitely should.
I think the 49ers went about it the right way. The GM for the 49ers reached out to the GM of the Packers to try to make a deal. They were throwing options their way for a possible trade. The GM of the Packers said, yeah, no, this is just a situation, internal thing. I don't think that he actually reached out to Aaron Rodgers to try to persuade him to come to San Francisco. And quite honestly, Jeffrey, I don't know that you need to persuade Aaron Rodgers. If he was going to leave, he would probably go to San Francisco.
It's legit tampering when Kyle Shanahan goes on with Danny Patrick and says, that yes, we are very much interested in exploring an Aaron Rodgers trade. Doing that right there, that's tampering. That is actual tampering. As far as the definition of what tampering is that I've already just read to you, going on a radio show, i.e. news media, that counts as tampering. So the Packers, did the Packers get anything for that trouble? Do they get draft picks that are taken away from the 49ers and Broncos and given to the Packers?
No.
Is there any benefit to them other than being as petty as Aaron Rodgers and going after them for tampering?
No, they just get the knowledge and I don't know, the satisfaction of knowing that the other team suffered because of it. But it's that is dumb, because that's like saying any team in the NFL right now is not allowed to compliment or say, of course, if Patrick Mahomes was free and available, we would, of course, want a shot at him. That's any team in the NFL. That's not the Kansas City Chiefs. And even the Chiefs would say, of course, he's our guy. He's going to be with us forever and ever until we both die. Whatever. They're all going to want
Speaking
him.
Of Chiefs, remember Jeremy Maclin from 2015 and the old tampering thing there where the Chiefs lost a draft pick? It's hard to prove, but not impossible. And the Packers, head office over there, they are telling the NFL, they are stating, there's been tampering. There has been tampering. And now if they've got some solid proof.
Yeah, it depends on the evidence.
Yeah, I hope they do go after him.
If somebody sent a text message, if somebody sent a couple too many friendly winky emojis somewhere saying, hey, Aaron Rodgers, check your DMs. Wait, we're sliding in there, and then asking him if he would sign a long-term
I think winky emojis should be considered tampering immediately.
Yeah. Yeah, well, absolutely.
Consider you guys tampered. I'm going
to also a man guard violation.
I'm going to tamper you guys right now.
Oh, no.
Why don't you just go tamper yourself? Let's go to the text line and get it caught up there. Flying Monkey says, Aaron Rodgers is a whiny-ass bitch. I hope the Packers trade him to the NFL in Serbia. I don't think they have one of those, but
I don't think so.
Yeah,
no.
I'm all for it. Jet says, happy Friday, gentlemen. It's my birthday. Randy, how about a beer, please?
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday, Jet. Thanks so much for tuning in, man. Boomer Sooner says, Terry Bradshaw says he's weak, says he should shut up and play. Who cares if he doesn't like it? Okay, Terry Bradshaw is the old man in his boxer shorts and black socks and tank top standing on the lawn yelling at the kids in the neighborhood who aren't actually there.
How did you know about that? I do that every week.
Nobody needs to listen to Terry Bradshaw. He might be right about a couple of things, but he's completely detached from reality. Should he shut up and play? Yeah. If he is able to make a good deal with the Packers. Yeah. If he doesn't want to, all right, let him retire. Outside of that. Yeah. Eventually he'll shut up and play, but I don't know. I hate that I agree with some of what Bradshaw says, but I also hate that it's him saying it.
Yeah, but the part you don't agree with is so much so that you just feel dirty agreeing with any part of it.
What? Just Tip says, I don't see a trade that would allow Aaron Rodgers to leave the Packers. Maybe the Colts, because they can actually afford him, but not sure if the Colts have any value to trade back to Green Bay.
Here's the thing.
Yeah, draft picks, Just the Tip. Shut up.
Here's the thing is, truly, tell me that this doesn't make a lot of sense, is if you're the Broncos, you are loaded up on offense. What is the one thing that the Packers, if they give up on Aaron Rodgers, that they would want? They would want a couple of offensive pieces to give to Jordan Love to ensure to give him the best chance, like the New York Giants are doing with Daniel Jones right now, give him the best surrounding cast to showcase and highlight that, okay, if there's a problem with this offense,
too complicated.
If this offense happens, we know it's on your fault.
Too complicated. You know what it is? You're right, Just a Tip. The Colts can give you Wentz and draft picks. You're going to at least be able to play your games and at least have some dignity in the next season. Broncos, that's just a cluster bleep. That's all that is. Don't listen to Phil, Packers.
You're just trying to get him on the Colts, and it makes no sense whatsoever.
You're trying to get him on the Broncos. It doesn't make any sense,
It makes a lot of sense. They're the number one reported team.
You know, we're the number one team that wears blue and white. Suck on that.
Yeah.
Daily Blender here on 1580, the Fanatic. Yeah.
I need these boxes in bin 7. Oh, hello. Hi. I just wanted to call in and find out when
Whitney's warehouse foreman just retired, and the replacement needs to move to fulfillment.
Hold on. Guys, can we get the dock cleared now?
Indeed can help her hire the people she needs.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. When you sponsor a job, you immediately get your short list of quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job criteria.
Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
Last summer, Arizona experienced record heat. Hottest summer in Arizona history. 145 days of 100 plus degrees, 53 days of over 110. Summer heat is starting sooner and it's lasting longer, and your power bills are more expensive every year. Take control of your power bills. Call Harmon Solar today. Harmon Solar is locally owned and operated. They use top-of-the-line equipment, and they're A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau. Call Harmon Solar, 800-281-3189, or go to harmonsolar.com. Harmon Solar is an REC-certified solar professional.
Hi, I'm Steve.
And I'm Felicia.
We're the hosts of the show, Drive Friendly.
With Steve's 40 years of experience, you're going to get the real insider information about the automotive industry. And I'll be interviewing local celebrities and experts so you can be informed and live your very best life.
Laugh and learn with Steve, Felicia, and the gang. You'll be smarter for listening. Drive Friendly, 10 a.m. Saturday mornings on 1580 and 99.3, The Fanatic.
Hey guys, it's Stephen McCollum from the Main Event here on 1580 The Fanatic. Coming up on Monday at 1 p.m., I'll get you caught up on the weekend. The Diamondbacks were in New York, Suns take on the Knicks and Lakers, let's check out the NBA standing. Also, the Coyotes wrap up their season, let's take a look into the offseason, and let's see where this team goes from here. Join me, Stephen McCollum, on the Main Event, Monday at 1 p.m. on 1580, 99.3 FM, The Fanatic.
Last year, the series' most popular driver took home the championship.
This season,
it's anybody's guess who will win.
We celebrate Mother's Day at the Lady in Black, Darlington. Throwback weekend, 11:30 a.m. Sunday morning.
Don't miss a moment of the ground-pounding excitement of NASCAR.
Sponsored by Phoenix Raceway.
And your new epicenter for NASCAR racing in the Valley. 1580 and 99.3, The Fanatic.
In the Army National Guard, family means everything.
Our parents, they're really supportive that all five of us would join. I got my education because of the Guard. I got to travel a little bit and experience a whole different culture. It helped me get my job, helped me pay for my house.
Serving part-time in the Army National Guard instills pride that you and your family will share. Visit NationalGuard.com to learn more about part-time service. Sponsored by the Arizona Army National Guard, aired by the Arizona Broadcasters Association and this station.
The Fanatic.
The Daily Blender here on 1580, The Fanatic, Arizona's new home for sports. Tonight, 6 p.m., you get a fresh new episode of The Race Setup with Randy White and that chief guy. Fill us in. What's the show all about this week, kid?
Well, it's a special Mother's Day edition. Of course, you know, NASCAR will be at the Lady in Black, the Darlington Raceway this weekend for the Goodyear 400. That does not mean there'll be 400 tires made by Goodyear running
around
the track.
Someday my dream will come true, Randy.
It could be. Could be. But Alex Hayden from MRN will join us. We also we break down the new the next gen cars that were revealed this week. And we give you some insights there. Really cool, man. These cars are very technologically sound. And they put the original original equipment noses and tails on them, so they look really cool. If you get a chance, look up the NASCAR next gen cars.
All right, so there you go. That's the Race Setup with Randy White and that chief guy. That happens at 6 p.m. this afternoon, and then of course at 7 a.m. a replay for you guys in the morning. So if you're out and about, feel free to tune on in. And hey, one of the things that we get to hear from the listeners more than anything about the Race Setup is how much you learn. If you're a novice to the NASCAR, you can learn a lot by listening to this show. And yeah, I know I have. Anytime I've listened, I've been like, oh, so that's what that means. But if you have questions, if you're listening, you're like, well, what does that mean? Well, the Race Setup also has a Twitter page. You can go there and you can ask him a question about NASCAR there. What's your Twitter handle again?
At the Race Setup. All one word, at the Race Setup.
I can't believe you actually got that on the Twitter. Yeah, that was available for you just like that. Race Setup.
And we got some exciting news coming very shortly. We have secured the name, theracesetup.com. We will have a website as well. So it'll be lots of questions answered on there, more interactivity for you, some photos, all kinds of neat stuff. That's That'll be at the racesetup.com.
Boomer Sooner wants to know, is that a rifle behind Randy on the couch there?
Yeah, it is. I purchased a device. I can hang that on the wall. That's my AR. That's my pride and joy right there.
Mm-hmm. Why is it sitting on the couch like it's watching a show instead of being hung up on the wall?
Well, I haven't had a chance to get to it. There's been just a few things going on here in the house. Mm. Hopefully this weekend it will be mounted and look very cool.
Can I play with it? The rifle, Phil.
Yeah, yeah. Of course you can, Jeffco.
We should go shooting sometime.
I'd love that. Love that.
Fighting Wampa says, not sure if she's a mother, but I wanted to wish Jen in accounting all the mothers out there happy Mother's Day.
She will be soon. Happy Mother's Day.
Yeah, absolutely.
Jeff Van Gundy, we were talking about the Aaron Rodgers fiasco. He says, you know, there comes a time when you have to admit a quarterback has lost his spark. Look at Peyton, where he was carried by that defense in Denver. Mm-hmm. If the Packers really thought Aaron Rodgers was a secure investment, they would have already put pen to paper. Well, that's the thing, though, Jeff Van Gundy, they did. They offered him a deal that would have made him the NFL's highest paid quarterback already earlier this season. Yeah. And I'm not sure what the hitch is on that. Maybe he really believed his own hype that they would have to trade him if he demanded it, that they would have to do these things. So whatever it is, he's trying to punish the Packers because they drafted Jordan Love. And he thinks with the MVP next to his name, he can do that.
Highest paid quarterback is so interpretive these days because when you don't know what the guaranteed money is and you don't know what it is for how long it is.
Jeffrey, is he going to dance again? Probably. Interpretive stuff?
Yeah, and it's always very awkward.
And here's the thing is that Aaron Rodgers, even though he could be the highest paid quarterback ever that we've ever seen, that could only still be for 2 years. And if it's only for 2 years, what does that do for him? That doesn't accomplish anything that he wants. He's coming off of an MVP season.
I think
season.
I'm going to be sick.
Yeah, I'm
going
to turn
off
his
of an
camera.
MVP season. So he proved to the Packers and to the entire
okay,
world.
There you go. There you go. We are.
All right. What's that?
Now that I've done that, though, I worry that now people can't hear it.
Yeah.
I don't know. I don't know. Yeah. I couldn't tell you.
I could still hear him.
Yeah. You guys can still hear me. The radio can still hear me. We're all fine. But coming off an MVP season, he proved that he still has it. Even if he loses his quote-unquote spark, he's not going to just completely fall off of a cliff.
You have to turn the camera back.
I don't want
to
turn it on. See. He's still dancing, though. He's turning it back off. Turning it back off.
He's still dancing.
That's too much. Too much. Yeah. Too much.
And keep in mind, Van Gundy, that Aaron Rodgers was the league MVP this year. So I'm thinking he's still got enough gas in the tank to be relevant and to light a spark on this Packers team. The Packers are doing nothing to help them out, though. So there you go.
Jeff Van Gundy also says, what in the world is that reaction, Phil? Peyton was dragged into the 2016 Super Bowl ring. He's my quarterback. Yeah, here's the thing. To be fair, Jeff Van Gundy, that was more about the Broncos defense than anything else. But he did bring stability. He did bring order. He did bring a veteran presence. And he did. He managed that offense into being just adequate enough to get that win. And so you have to give him some credit. But, most of the credit should go to that defense.
And he had three MVP-like caliber seasons before, one of which he did win an MVP. The other one, he came up in second, that he came up to Adrian Peterson's massively, motivating comeback season year after coming back off of an Achilles. Otherwise, he would have won it running away. So I don't know what you're talking about as far as what you mean am I deserving. Peyton Manning, on the year that he won the Super Bowl, but when the Colts got rid of him, he had three more fantastic years in him and one more year where he was capable enough to win a Super Bowl.
That last year, though, it was right that he left after that Super Bowl.
Yeah, well, it was the right timing for Peyton to get out there.
Sure, absolutely. Yeah. But that doesn't negate the fact that having a quarterback who's essentially a coach on the field and can at the very least get you into the basic play style, whether or not he can get it there is another issue, but he can get you into the right, we should really run. Oh, wait, we should really have a play action here. Oh, wait, we should just straight up pass.
Boomer Sooner says, ooh, great intro music. Yeah, we're doing pretty good today. Did really great tomorrow, except for one song. Sorry, David Brad. I have to always say that. Bruce's buddy says, you know what? Just bleep the Steelers. That's all I've got. Bleep the Steelers.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Well, looks like it's going to be a long season for them.
Chamoy says tampering in the NFL is the biggest joke. If Gruden can actively recruit Richard Sherman free agency on Chris Collinsworth's stupid podcast and nothing happens, I think any team kicking tires on Aaron Rodgers should be okay.
You know, yeah, that's a good point.
I got to be honest. What if we just got rid of tampering altogether? Then at least it would all be out there on the surface, because I got news for you. Every team, every coach, every GM tampers. Every one of them do it. Now, I don't like when people break rules and then use the excuse, well, everyone does it. That's not what this is. This is just a realization that everybody is out there tampering. I would almost guarantee it. Do I have proof? No, because a lot of them are good at just not getting caught. But I would just about guarantee you everybody is tampering, which is why the rule is silly and that you should just get rid of it. Anybody make a good case on why tampering it should still be a rule?
I understand why it's still in place, but it is extremely outdated. I mean, come on, you got to evolve here, get into the new millennium. Come on.
Boogie says, happy Mother's Day to Jen from accounting. Yep. And, oh, wow, this is a great photo. Now, it looks like somebody's ready for poker night. Boogie is sitting there with his poker table. He's got his metal case of chips, and he's put some money on the table. Looks like Boogie likes to play poker high. $20 bills right there.
Wow.
That's some high stakes poker right there.
Boogie, what you playing? You playing Omaha? You playing Pineapple? You playing Hold'em? What are we playing?
Did he say pineapple?
Was that really you trying to be clever and tell me I've got a problem with my audio?
No.
Is there really a poker game called Pineapple?
Yeah. Wow.
Never heard of it.
Yeah, Pineapple. We got High-Low, Pot Limit, Omaha.
I didn't hear anything wrong with your feet.
There's nothing wrong with your feet.
Why do you say pineapple? Yeah. But I will say this about Boogie. What I'm really also glad to see in this photograph is it's almost a smile. He's almost smiling in this photograph.
Right. So all right, good for you, Boogie.
Poker will make even the sourest man a little happy.
What? Sure. Do you say he's got a hooker in the room?
No.
You said poker. I thought he said hooker.
Ah.
Oh, sorry. Boy, I misheard that.
I mean, I guess it depends on the hooker.
Well, now we know what Phil's doing this weekend. 888-368-1580. Another stellar photograph there, Boogie. Well done on that. Well done. Boy, don't I look good. He's wearing his Jeffrey O'Brien is better than me at everything shirt, which he'll be wearing right up until the first season game for the NFL.
Now, is that exhibition or first official game?
First official game.
Ah, okay.
Yeah.
All right, just wanted to make sure that
season-starting game.
As Boogie's legitimate show counsel, I want to make sure we're crystal clear on all the ramifications of this bet.
Sure, I'm sort of torn because part of me, just because I enjoy getting these photos so much, kind of hopes for an NFL walkout. Because the official game could go further out, and then we'd get more of these pictures, because Boogie would never welch on his bet. No. Hell no, we wouldn't. No.
See, what you need to do is you need to make a bet where it starts on MLB season next year, because that's definitely going to be a holdout.
Mm. See, thanks for the idea, but don't bring that up again. I might need it. Fish Tank says, but is he wearing that shirt at the actual poker table? Yeah, he is. I got a picture. Go look for it on the Twitter. I'm going to retweet it here in just a little bit. And you know what? This is a good time for us to remind you. Hey, follow us on Twitter.
Yeah.
I'll follow you back. Here's what you do. First and foremost, the radio station is at 1580 The Fanatic.
Hold on, let me get a pen.
Randy is at Radio 777.
At Radio Randy.
Sorry.
Yeah, 777.
Sorry. At Radio Randy 777. Phil is Filthy Speedo with a PH on the Phil for Filthy Speedo. And then I am Radio Pal 1580. So there you go. Those are our Twitters. Take a moment when you get a chance. Follow us there. You can find a connection to us pretty easily at 1580 The Fanatic. So Jeff Van Gundy says, shut up, Phil. Peyton was carried by Noshon, Moreno, Julius Thomas, and Wes Welker.
Well, that is the most outdated and ignorant statement I've ever heard. Are you saying for the first 3 years? For the last year,
God, he called Jeff Van Gundy ignorant.
Yeah. For the last year, you have a semi-fair point, I suppose, because he did get swapped out with Brock Osweiler. But those first 3 years, he had an MVP caliber level season all three of those years. You just need to stop it and check yourself.
Boogie is checking myself. He says 18 weeks left and no, lockouts don't count. Really? You think so? No, the deal was the next regular season game. Just because on your calendar, you think you know when the next regular season game is, lockouts, I think, should count.
You would need to get an impartial judge as the third person, even though
Well, Randy just said he's his counsel, so it can't be Randy.
Yeah.
You were just going to make some sort of a, ruling based on speedos. So I'd have to find somebody out there who we could trust as an impartial, person.
If there, if in the event of a holdout, all parties involved must wear speedos of their own team.
You will never judge nothing.
No.
I don't know what to do on this one.
No.
Well, let's just hope that we get our NFL season and this does not become a legal battle between me and Boogie. Because here's the thing. Even if he stops taking the pictures, well, he will still be responsible for those pictures if I win in the court battle. I'm just saying. Better lawyer up, Boogie, if you're really going to try to Welch on this bet. Hour three coming up next. The Daily Blender here on 1580 The Fanatic.
Everybody, Mark Asher, about to tell you about my friends at Valley Medical Weight Loss. I love this company. I've used them. I have friends that have used them. A ton of weight has been lost in a quick amount of time. And the right way. That's the important part. Look, they have three Valley locations, Tempe, Glendale, and Phoenix. So one is close to you. And they've been doing this for well over a decade. And right now, you can get your first week, $31.95, absolutely free. Just mention Money Radio or mention The Fanatic, and it is on them. 602-441-3305 or valleymedicalweightloss.com.
I'm Cisco Miranda, owner of Miranda Delivery Service. As a business owner, my job is to provide the best quality service for our customers. Affinity Technology helped us reinvent our business processes using technology to make us more efficient. I didn't know I needed technology consulting, but my ROI has been off the charts. Affinity Technology has saved us more than 80 man hours a week and has helped me get back to what I do best, focus on my customers. Visit atechaz.com. That's atechaz.com and see how better technology processes can help your small business.
Last year, the series' most popular driver took home the championship.
This season,
it's anybody's guess who will win.
We celebrate Mother's Day at the Lady in Black, Darlington, Throwback Weekend, 11:30 a.m. Sunday morning.
Don't miss a moment of the ground-pounding excitement of NASCAR.
Sponsored by Phoenix Raceway.
And your new epicenter for NASCAR racing in the Valley. 1580 and 99.3.
The Fanatic.
Last summer, Arizona experienced record heat. Hottest summer in Arizona history. 145 days of 100 plus degrees, 53 days of over 110. Summer heat is starting sooner and it's lasting longer, and your power bills are more expensive every year. Take control of your power bills. Call Harmon Solar today. Harmon Solar is locally owned and operated. They use top of the line equipment and they're A-plus rated with the Better Business Bureau. Call Harmon Solar, 800-281-3189 or go to harmonsolar.com. Harmon Solar is an REC certified solar professional.
Market Wrap host Mo Ansari talks about the dangers of emotional investing.
There's two things that people sell. One is greed and one is fear. Whenever you buy either one of those, you're going to end up getting burned because they are the epitome of emotions. And you've heard me say, whenever emotions take over, you're in trouble. If you don't want that to happen to you, give us a call. We'll be more than happy to do an objective evaluation of your portfolio to find the right degree of risk, what you have in your portfolio, what you should have, depending on your age, depending on your emotional makeup, depending on your financial makeup, depending on what your objectives are. All of those things go in to determine the correct balance of portfolio. We'll do that for you. It is free. You have to at least get started.
If you're ready to get started, call #250 and say talk to Mo or go to compaq.com and click on the get started button. That's compaq.com.
Compaq Asset Management is a registered investment advisor, funds custodian, Fidelity Institutional Wealth Services, member FINRA, SIPC.
KQFN Tempe.
Also transmitting on K25CD Phoenix at 99.3 FM.
And K24EU Fountain Hills at 95.9 FM.
It's time for the third hour.
All right, people, settle down.
Because it's time.
Time for what?
Showtime.
When does it start?
Right now. 3, 2, 1.
Let's get on with the show.
Let's do it.
All right,
everybody. It's Friday here on the Daily Blender. I'm your good friend, your radio pal, Jeffrey O'Brien, alongside my heterosexual white partner, Randy White. We got Phil there in the Harvin Solar Studios in Scottsdale, and you guys are on the Snail Medical text line, 888-368-1580. And we may have some sort of a controversy in the bet between myself and Boogie. It requires him to wear a Jeffrey O'Brien is better at everything than me t-shirt once a week, taking the selfie up until the first game of the regular NFL season. Mm-hmm. And he's saying, well, no, lockout will not count. I'm saying does, because the bet wasn't until a specific date. The day it was till the first regular season NFL game starts. So I feel pretty good chances about my chances of winning if that were to happen. But now I'm curious. Now I'm kind of curious where that should end up.
I don't know. I think it would be a bit cruel and unusual to continue to make him wear that.
It's a wonderful t-shirt. He looks
great.
The
supposed first day of the real games, the games that matter.
Here's the difference. I think in the spirit of the bet, you would end it on when the first game should have been held. Yeah. But if you want to be legal and you go it all the way to the full extent in court of the law of the land, then you you would be correct in holding out until the first official game is played, even if that takes 5 years.
Okay. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll have Boogie put his hand on a stack of Bibles. Or vintage Playboys, whichever one works best for him.
Playboys.
Okay. And I'm going to have him under oath state, if it was the other way around, would you let me off the hook that easy? I don't think he would. I don't think he would. Boogie says, we've never even specified if it's for season or preseason. No, it was. I swear to God, Boogie, I'll go back and find audio. It was specified regular season.
That
I was saying during the during this bet when we were first making it, regular season, the
now
actual start of the season.
I did hear that. Yes,
you did.
I did hear that.
Because now
I will corroborate with him.
You are here, Phil.
No, what I was here. Ever since any time I've heard mention of this bet, it had not been established that it was a regular season versus preseason game. It had never been established. I'd just been enjoying the fruits
it's
of your labor.
Established in the when we wrote it up and put it up actually up on the fantasy football site.
I'm just saying from what I had heard from my interactions with the show, even though I wasn't here at the inception of it, everything I had heard had just been a game. It had not been specified to preseason.
It didn't have to be specified because it was in print. We already had it in print. So I just said until the next season. So I didn't feel like I needed to nitpick on every little detail verbally when I've got it in print. Boogie says Randy is correct. It would be cruel and mostly unusual punishment to maybe have a shirt with your ugly mug on it.
I appreciate that. Yeah, his mug is not ugly. It is. It's a very handsome. You have to admit, Boogie. There is a handsomeness, a debonair, swashbuckling, dare I say?
Oh yeah.
Feel to Jeffrey. Now come on.
Now, by the way, Boogie, you've never looked better than when you wear that shirt. Well, I would bet you get hit on constantly. And I know have to say, hey, ladies, my eyes are up here. I get it.
Yeah.
But I, if you were smart, you'd keep wearing that shirt long after this bet is over.
Mm.
Baker's Cocky Hen says Boogie should have to wear the shirt during sex and send a pic showing you're the dominant man.
Boy. Yeah. No.
That's a bit far. I'm going to have to probably say no on that one, please.
I hate that you said probably. That's something I would have said.
I don't want to see these pictures, but no. Baker's Cocky Hens also says, we should have a Texas Hold'em tournament for the fourth dimension. I'll take everyone down.
Absolutely.
All right.
Bring that does sound chips. Like fun. And now that gambling is becoming more and more legal in Arizona, we might be able to figure out how to actually do that with the radio station. I'll have to talk to Radio Ron about that. That does sound pretty fun.
You guys play? Do you guys play?
No, yeah, we win.
Oh, nice.
Oh, wait, Randy, watch this. No, I've never played poker before, Phil. Nice. Can I be in your game?
I guess so. Probably.
In the next week, Phil has a barrel. He's got nothing but a barrel, like in the old cartoons. Jeff Van Gundy says, Phil, why are you defending Peyton Manning so hard? He was simply below average when he was in Denver. Well, he was below average for Peyton Manning.
Year.
for the Broncos, that was the best thing they've ever seen since Elway.
Yeah. What do you mean? What am I? This isn't even something that I'm homering it up. It is undeniable that the first three seasons he spent in Denver, he had an MVP like, if not an actual MVP caliber season year in and year out until that last one, which I grant you was not his best. And he retired as probably at his lowest point in his career. What am I doing here? That's not just complete logic.
What was Phil talking about just now?
I don't know. Something about lowest point in the career, which is what I'm waiting for so I can retire.
Oh, when he said lowest point in the career, I thought it meant since we had to work with Phil.
Then I'm going to have to retire.
You know what? It's been a good run. Both Randy and I have decided that it's time to retire.
How convenient. With a whole hour to go.
Yeah. Phil, take it from here. And I don't know what's going to happen next week.
All right.
As soon as Phil then like wanders off, and then like the next week we're like, is he gone? We're back.
Let's go back to the Hawks demolishing the Phoenix Suns.
I'm not coming in if you guys aren't gonna be there. Okay, we're not gonna be there.
I'll meet you around the corner. Ugla Mock says, hey, I'm impartial, Radio Pal, even though you killed my dog. Well, that makes you not impartial, so there's no way we're gonna do this.
Yeah.
Hefty Lefty says, guys. Maker's Cocky Hen says, don't worry, I got a case of chips from winning a tournament against 100 plus people at a random bar once. Yeah, but what's the chance of that lightning striking twice, Baker's Cocky Hens? Blissful Hay says, hey, the Dimebags are up 3-0 right now.
How about that?
Is he talking about the Diamondbacks? I don't know. Yeah, we called them the Dimebags now. Or is that just a rude thing that's being said?
I don't know.
Yeah, they're the up three. Bags. Well, now they're up. I can't tell. Hold on.
Let's see. The Jet says, don't leave Phil in charge. The fourth dimension is going to eat him alive.
Welcome to the buffet, baby.
Oh, Jesus. Wow. Jeff Van Gundy says, you are definitely a homer, Phil. This is the most ridiculous thing I've heard on the radio from you since, well, yesterday. Good Cat says, Randy, I need to celebrate. 6 beers, please. I just learned that I will be done with my student loans as of July 1st.
Hey!
It's only taken 16 years to pay these things off, but there you go, buddy. Congratulations.
Fantastic.
Congratulations. Yeah, there's one.
Go get yourself a car.
You Arizona student loans. Boy, you sure took your sweet time paying that $43 back, didn't you?
Yeah. Oh, boy. Yeah. 43.
I love Good Cat, but I had to. Cabana says, you guys know, I can't say that right now because that's part of on this day in big Georgia sports history. In fact, today is a multi on this day in big Georgia sports history. He's on by vacation, by the way. He's on his honeymoon in Hawaii with his lovely new bride, and they're out there having a good time. So he did not send one last night, so you know what that means.
Well, you had to write one up. Right? Am I right?
Yeah.
Am I right?
Yeah. Yeah. I had to do extra work. Swave Dave says, you know, I don't do the whole social media thing, but if you follow me, I'll lead. Okay. Well, just if you follow me, I'll follow you back. I don't know what the rest of that means. Baby Got Dax says, happy F day, everyone. I'm pretty sure she means Friday. It seems there's a new report coming out on Aaron Rodgers that he's most upset with the front office for trading away what he thought were key players for success. My guess, this started when Jordy Nelson was sitting down the driveway years ago. Imagine over time. Sure, that started to kind of grate on him, the guys he did at least have some good chemistry with. Let's see here. Just a Tip says, can't wait for the race setup. Alex Hayden, he's really informative, and I'm very impressed with the rapport that Randy and Chief have developed with Alex Hayden. Three friends talking NASCAR, but
that's all it is.
With some insight, news, and insight.
Yeah. Thank you very much.
Is kind of become like your PR guy. He's writing basically press releases for your show now.
I love it. I love it. Thanks, Just the Tip.
That right there is amazing. What are you doing, Phil?
I love it.
What's wrong with you? Are you still just bitter because you can't win in an argument with
Broncos? There's no way I lose that. Anybody with common sense.
There is a way. We keep talking over you and not letting you get your point out. We've made sure you lose that.
I don't think that's true.
Guys.
Large Marge says, I want Phil to know that since he bailed on the Phoenix Suns, they are now 29-9. Can't make this stuff up on Philigan's Island.
Yeah, you can't make it up either. See you in the playoffs, big boy.
Oh, brother.
Oh, wow.
You know how impossible. I'll have to fire him.
Yeah.
Because he'll be impossible. Yeah. And even if I fire Phil for what is sure to be just the worst thing you've ever heard, he'll probably still, even fired, stand outside the window and scream into it all sorts of stuff about the Lakers.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You know how the window things are usually open?
Yeah.
I'll be outside of them.
Yeah, they'll be closed. They'll be closed, and I'll probably get some German Shepherds out there, too. I hope you can run, kid. I hope you can run.
German Shepherds and snapping turtles.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right. Yeah, those things will go for a speedo that.
Bam.
Lacrosse guy says, here's a dream trade. Aaron for Kyler and Cliff Dingleberry.
Mm.
Would you make the trade, Randy?
It's
time to rise up.
Actually, no, I'm going to ask you the serious question. If they said Aaron Rodgers, you give us the coach and you give us the quarterback, would you do it?
The coach I'd have no problem with because he hasn't done anything. But what do you do with the future of the Cardinals after Aaron is done?
Who cares?
What do?
Finally,
you
win your Super Bowl.
You got how is that guaranteed? Is that assured? Is that guaranteed?
I'd say yes.
No, it's
I'd
not guaranteed.
You've got all the weapons right now. You got a defense that's going to be great. You've got an offense that's going to be pretty good. You got a lot of good players there, a lot of good receivers. Stuff that Aaron Rodgers hasn't even had over there in Green Bay. If he can do with Green Bay what he did year in and year out, imagine what he would do with the Arizona. I guarantee you a Super Bowl if that fantasy fictitious trade were to ever happen.
I don't know. Aaron is older. You only have him for a couple of years.
You only need him for the years to get a Super Bowl.
Yeah, but then after that, we go back to mediocrity again. Do you know how hard we've worked to get back to mediocrity?
You think this is going
to
last forever?
I mean, we used to really
anyway?
Suck, and now we're going to be mediocre last year, and now we're going to be above mediocrity.
Randy, all teams go in and out like the tide, even the great teams. So if you have a place to strike, you strike. You do what you got to do. Your team doesn't have a whole lot of time. And the other part is that Kime's gone out and got a bunch of guys who are long in the tooth. You've got a lot of older guys. It's funny because your locker room is both really old and really young. There doesn't seem to be a lot of in between. This is your best shot. You better hope that everything that Kime has done draft and free agency wise ends up being a deep run in the playoffs or even a hope of a Super Bowl. That's got to happen now because next year, a lot of these guys are going to be gone.
Well, we'll have to wait and see what happens next year. We're going to go one day at a time, one game at a time this year and see how the Cardinals play. But look, this is irrelevant. There's no way that you can guarantee a Super Bowl. Now, do our odds increase? You could
Jeffrey O'Brien.
Your house on it. Yeah. You could do whatever you want.
I
get it. But what do you do 2 years down the road? What do
you
do 2 years down the road?
You worry about that later. Yes.
Years down the road.
Yeah, Phil looks. Why do you always look like you've smelled a fart today? You don't seem to agree with anything anybody is saying.
Yeah, I don't know what I ate. A couple donuts in the break room over there.
In the breast room.
Sorry,
I was thinking about
Jeffrey's.
Are you sitting on the toilet eating donuts and crying?
I was thinking about Jeffrey's chicken. Anyways,
what?
But what
is that, a euphemism? That sounds like a euphemism.
Really? Yeah. You have never seen in your lifetime an Arizona Cardinals Super Bowl. So you're throwing that away for continued possible mediocrity with the chance maybe of a Super Bowl down the road? What is that? What is that?
And a chance this year if Aaron Rodgers were to come here. A chance at maybe going to the Super Bowl again. Remember, he was the MVP last year, and he didn't go to the damn Super Bowl.
Would you say
fault? Keep that in mind. Bay Buccaneers are still the Tampa Bay Buccaneers.
Would you say
Seattle Sea Chickens are still the Seattle Sea Chickens?
Randy, I don't like Aaron Rodgers. I don't even like him, but I can't say they got into the playoffs with Aaron Rodgers.
Got a number one seed.
And, it didn't go well, but still.
Right. Exactly my point.
Randy, would you say that?
No, with a crap team,
it's funny that you guys are trying to talk me into this, and you guys asked me the question. So why can't we just leave it with, I don't know if I would do that, and then we're all good, because I'm Randy White. I don't have to make that decision.
No, that's fine. That's fair. I'm stunned at the answer. Stunned at the answer.
That's what it is for me too. If we can practice, and even at its premise that we could guarantee you a Super Bowl, and you're saying no, the long term history of our franchise. What are you talking about?
Well, he told you what he's talking about.
You guys think that that Aaron Rodgers, now given everything we've said today about Aaron Rodgers, what a crybaby he is, how sensitive he is, how petty he is, what an asshat he is. And you guys are telling me bring him into Arizona for a quality quarterback that was in the running for the MVP last year and see if this chemistry would work here.
Aaron was.
I don't know that it would work here. And I cannot guarantee that we would have a Super Bowl berth or championship with Aaron Rodgers on our team.
Let's make it simpler. If Aaron Rodgers guaranteed, like, we could sell you a house
I don't know that I would make that move.
All right, that's fair. You know what? That's Randy's opinion. Now, I'm the guy who has said, I'll take the ball deflating, Patriot cheating some bitch on my Colts, given the chance. Yeah. I'm the guy who has said, I'll take Aaron Rodgers, who I really don't like, on my Colts, given the chance. I'm the guy who said he would take Deshaun Watson, even if it turns out, just the rub and tug stuff. Just the rub it. If the other stuff, if it's assault, no, I want him to burn in hell. Yeah. But trust me, I will do whatever it takes to get my damn Super Bowl, especially after how long it's been. So, it's been longer for the Cardinals, but still, I'm just saying. So I do believe that. And when I'm not just saying this to gun you up. I honestly believe if you were to do that, get Aaron Rodgers in your team, Cardinals win the Super Bowl.
I think we're having two separate discussions. I don't know if I'm with Randy in the idea that I don't know if Aaron Rodgers alone makes you a Super Bowl contender.
Well, with that, what you already have. Yeah.
But I will say one, the Cardinals have a better
compliment
team.
Compliment to your team, Randy.
Yeah. I have the team for the Cardinals around him than what the Green Bay Packers have for him.
We've just discovered he's a douchebag. He's sensitive. No.
So, I said it's a compliment to your team that I say that about your team being good enough to win a Super Bowl if you had Aaron Rodgers. I'm not saying it's a compliment to your team to get him.
I just don't. There's got to be chemistry between the players, all the weapons, and the quarterback.
Yeah, we already know DeAndre Hopkins.
Who knows how it would have? It probably would work out real good.
Phil,
but then we go.
Here's what I want you to do.
We would go backwards in a hurry.
I want you to go home this weekend. Get your Madden out. I want you to do simulations with Aaron Rodgers on the Cardinals, I want Kyler Murray on the Packers. Run some season simulations and tell me how that turns out. I guarantee you. A Super Bowl, Randy. I guarantee you.
How many simulations you want? Five seasons worth?
He won't be here five seasons.
No, I'm saying five
times.
Do you
have time to hit the button 10 times? Can we do 10?
Yeah.
You game on other systems too, right?
Yeah.
So it wouldn't just be completely ruining your weekend, would it?
No. I've got time. I may not have it exactly on Monday, but I can bring it in as soon as I can.
All right, let's just, and even that doesn't mean it changes Randy's mind. It doesn't prove me right. I'm just curious statistically how that whole thing would go down. And then hopefully all your teams are updated by Madden, and it's where you have the current configuration.
Well, that's the one to determine is that they won't have.
I'm actually helping you, Randy, with that.
Randy, we're trying to help you, and you're over here just spitting in our face.
I don't see any help. I see a bunch of badgering for me to change my mind. And I won't change my mind.
Okay, Randy, I don't want you to change your mind. I am just trying to present to you some information. That's all I'm doing.
It's hard to change your mind, Randy, when you're saying, I don't know. How can we change your mind from I don't know? You're right. It's your toe in
because
both
once bowl, he knows, right? He knows. So and if I show him something, might help him know.
I bet the vast majority of the fourth dimension would agree with me. You cannot guarantee.
All right, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll go to the text line right after this break. Guys, do you think adding Aaron Rodgers, taking little Kyler Murray off the Cardinals would guarantee it? What the hell, man?
You called him little Kyler Murray again.
Did I? I don't think I did. I think we should rewind the tape and find out. I don't think I did.
Oh, we'll rewind it. Don't worry. All right. We'll rewind
it. Okay, let me restate this. if Aaron Rodgers came to the Cardinals and Kyler Murray went to the Pats. Why?
I started to say Oompa Loompa. I know exactly what you're doing.
You should blow a whistle on yourself. Maybe I was saying Oompa Pa. You don't know what I was going
to
say.
Oh, yeah? Well, that's another whistle on you for telling me to whistle myself.
In my heart, you just did. Anyways, we'll figure this out when we come back. But text in. Do you think the Cardinals would automatically get a Super Bowl if Aaron Rodgers suddenly was at the helm? It's the Daily Blender here on 1580, the Oompa Loompa Fanatic.
I need these boxes in bin 7. Oh, hello. Hi. I just wanted to call in and find out when.
Whitney's warehouse foreman just retired, and the replacement needs to move to fulfillment. Hold
on. Guys, can we get the dock cleared now?
Indeed can help her hire the people she needs.
I need Indeed.
Indeed you do. When you sponsor a job, you immediately get your short list of quality candidates whose resumes on Indeed match your job criteria. Visit Indeed.com/credit and get $75 towards your first sponsored job. Terms and conditions apply.
You might not know it, but your small business IT systems can leave you and your customers vulnerable. At Affinity Technology, we provide peace of mind by ensuring your computer systems are working and are safe from hackers and outside threats. We solve technology problems for small business. No confusing tech talk or black box setups. If it plugs in, we work with it. Contact us today at atechaz.com. That's atechaz.com. Affinity Technology.
Last year, the series' most popular driver took home the championship.
This season,
it's anybody's guess who will win.
We celebrate Mother's Day at the Lady in Black, Darlington. Throwback weekend, 11:30 a.m. Sunday morning.
Don't miss a moment of the ground-pounding excitement of NASCAR.
Sponsored by Phoenix Raceway.
And your new epicenter for NASCAR racing in the Valley. 1580 and 99.3.
The Fanatic.
AZ Preps is a two-hour in-depth look at the Arizona Prep sports scene. Saturdays from 8 a.m. to 10 a.m. Covering all aspects of the Arizona Interscholastic Association. AZ Preps 365 focuses on all Arizona high school sports, student athletes, news, and notes from around Arizona. Join your host, Jose Garcia, Greg Quintide, and James Mello as they cover the prep sports scene from A to Z. AZ Preps 365, Saturday mornings from 8 to 10 on 1580 The Fanatic, Arizona's new home for sports.
Being in the Army National Guard is about more than serving your country. It's about being there for your community when your neighbors need you most. The Army National Guard makes college affordable, and serving part-time can help you graduate debt-free. Do you want to stay close to friends and family? The Guard allows you to serve close to home. Serving part-time in the Army National Guard lets you have the life you want. Learn more by visiting NationalGuard.com.
Sponsored by the Arizona Army National Guard, aired by the Arizona Broadcasters Association and this station.
1580 and 99.3, The Fanatic is now your exclusive home for the six-time world champion
indoor football league's Arizona Rattlers. Tune in to The Fanatic for all of the fast-paced, hard-hitting action.
Listen as the Arizona Rattlers vie for the playoffs and their seventh championship in team history. Arizona Rattlers football, exclusively on your new home for sports. 1580 and 99.3, The Fanatic.
And always on at 1580thefanatic.com.
Daily Blender here on 1580, The Fanatic, Arizona's new home for sports. All right, so let's go to the text line. The question has been put before you. Do you think the Arizona Cardinals would automatically win a Super Bowl this year just by swapping Kyler Murray out for Aaron Rodgers? Let's go to the text line, 888-368-1580. Roll Tide Ryan says they would have a better chance with Rodgers. I do think that Kyler is overrated. Well, better chance isn't really the point. The question is, do you believe they would actually win the Super Bowl because of this? Daylight Drew says, hey, guys, pour me a Maker's Mark with a large ice cube and go Diamondbacks, go Suns. Coyotes are out, but yeah, all right. Thanks, Daylight Drew. Baker's Cocky Hymns says, I think the Packers with Kyler Murray would finish better than the Cardinals with Aaron Rodgers. Overrated, man. Overrated. Wow. Seriously, dude is not that great. He always has a great line. Running backs that can catch, and yes, so easily he's got these outlets. Decent receivers. Rodgers, he's a fake. Give me Phil Rivers and his nine kids over him any day.
Oh, stop.
Wow.
Stop it.
Wow. That is a lot there to unpack, right?
Wow.
Lacrosse guy says, Kyler Murray is a video gamer with no heart, Randy. Rodgers is way better. Do the trade.
I didn't say he wasn't. I said he's older and we have a better chance of multiple championships with Kyler Murray, in my opinion. That's all I said.
Multiple? Silly Wabbit says, you can't fire Phil. It's hard to find part-time workers these days, you know. I believe Rodgers would give them a Super Bowl, though, this year. But Green Bay would come up a little short with Kyler Murray. So that's what Silly Wabbit has to say. Killer Rabbit says, the Cardinals would not automatically get a Super Bowl with Aaron Rodgers. Plus, you'd be giving away too much in a trade. Really, all we said, believe scenario. Swave Dave says, oh, hell no. Aaron Rodgers would not guarantee nothing. Maybe I should have said better chance. Melissa Hayes says, this Aaron Rodgers to the Cardinals talk is a little insulting to Kyler Murray. Just a little. Shamoy says, no, Kyler Murray's not the problem. Cliff Kingleberry is.
Yeah.
Jagdog says, that's a no on the trade. Prison Wallet says, Randy, Aaron Rodgers is of all of those things, but he's also the bad things, but he's also a guy that shows up on Sunday, doesn't punch a girl in the elevator, doesn't get pulled over for drunk driving, doesn't shoot anybody in a strip club. Mm-hmm. And that's a guy who wins games.
Yeah.
Hefty Lefty says, to Randy's point, though, the Packers' offensive weapons were pretty much equal to the Cardinals last year. So why would it make more of a guarantee for him to make the Super Bowl with the Cards over the Packers? Sorry, I don't agree. I don't agree that the Packers' offense was equal, to the Cardinals. Packers and Cardinals. Phil? Do you think he's right on that? Did the Packers have a comparable offense? Well, okay, let me stop here. We're not talking about last year. Let's say the Cardinals this year, because the free agency moves have greatly improved, the Cardinals' situation. So it would really be more about this year, Hefty Lefty. You might be right about last year, but I'm not even sure. Last year, were the Packers' offense and the Cardinals' offense similar?
No, they were extremely similar. If you think about it, a true number one wide receiver, far above anybody else within their wide receiver core, with Devontae Adams to DeAndre Hopkins. That comparison is completely legitimate. We look at the tight end or lack thereof for both teams. That's pretty much a wash. If anything, Aaron Jones and Jamal Williams and A.J. Dillon being in the backfield for Green Bay provides a better running back group altogether, running back tandem, than the Cardinals currently roster even now. So I'd say that's completely fair. But where I'd make the argument that the team is better is tremendously much more so in favor of the Cardinals even this year, even last year, if Chandler Jones were healthy, goes in the favor of the Cardinals more so than in the Packers.
All right, Just the Tip says, I would not trade for Kyler or for Aaron. I'm with Randy. Cards' best chance for multiple Super Bowl wins is with Kyler Murray.
Okay. I think so because he's younger and he's uber talented.
I think your window is going to be closing here pretty soon, buddy.
Yeah.
I better have some M&Ms. Baker's Cocky Hens says, half your team gets drafted first or second round, and you suck in the NFL. Schload of team, if you ask me. That's my baseball.
What is he talking about? It sounds like he's about two Irish car bombs in.
Yes. Have another drink. King of Kittens says, man, that Van Halen is kick ass. Yeah. And by the way, King of Kittens has a new throne. Oh, that's right. His remodel of his bathroom. And
nice.
I got to tell you, it's not bad right there. He's got his toilet is all put back in place. The tile's good. The paint is good. The backsplash on the tub. That's the rubber ducky shower curtain.
How about the backsplash of the toilet?
There's no backsplash of the toilet. It's fine. It doesn't need one because King of Kittens is a gentleman. He's not an uncivilized man. And I got the same paper, the same toilet paper holder as you. Cool, man. Well done. Good job. I know that was a lot of work for you. So have one on us.
Yeah.
Senior Wake and Bake says they couldn't win with Kurt Warner. Why do you think they'd win with Aaron Rodgers? The Crapnels, after all. It's a different team right now.
Well, I'm not going to go that far to say it's the Crapnels. It's my team. It's the Arizona Cardinals. And I feel like we're trending upward. And I just I appreciate your opinion, but mine just is a bit different. That's all.
I know, Average Joe, I was going to let it slide, but he says, hey, Phil, remember when Jeffrey asked you about the offenses and how you would compare them last year and then even this year? He says, Phil, Chandler Jones doesn't play offense. Nice job.
Thank you. And I said that. I said that the offenses compare definitely, but the teams, the biggest thing where
I
would
ask
say
you about the teams. I just asked you about the offenses.
Well, good. I wanted to expand upon the team. Thank you very
much. I didn't
want
you to expand upon the team. I wanted to expand the offense.
Oh, good. I'm glad I went and expanded to the team for the defense for those who are wondering.
No, nobody was wondering.
A lot of people were wondering.
0% of people were wondering.
I'd say about at least 3%.
I'm thinking nobody. Daylight Drew says, yeah, let's get Aaron in as quarterback. Yeah. Baby Got Dak says, I think no matter what team Aaron Rodgers plays on, even the Cardinals, if he had to face Brady and the Bucks in the Super Bowl, he would lose.
In the Super Bowl, that's...
Uka the Mock says, why is Phil Horseteeth even talking? Go Randy. Jeff Van Gundy says, Phil, dumbass, there's no such thing as a guaranteed Super Bowl. Whoa. Phil wasn't the one saying that. It was me. I was the one asking that question, not him.
Calm down, Jeff Van Gundy. Yes. Go back to Detroit.
Yeah, understand, wow. Jeff Van Gundy. He is a dumbass, but that was my question. So you want to launch that at anybody, you launch that at me. On this day in history, says Jeff Van Gundy, on 1580 Fanatic, Phil passes Bruce Jacobs for the most incorrect homer takes in history.
Wow. It's not true. He had an MVP caliber season.
I want to get Phil and Bruce in a conversation about Jets versus Broncos.
Oh, well, at least I have a Super Bowl in a generation of living.
That's the only thing you got on that, because there would be a big smoke cloud over whatever happened. Kind of like when those electrical transformers go and you get that ring, that smoke ring that goes up there. Yeah. Real Slim Shaney says that trade would never happen. Packers would come up a little short.
Well, here's the thing. If that trade were to happen, it would certainly enlarge the Cardinals' Super Bowl window. Right now, it's pretty short with Kyler Murray.
That was so obvious. I think he should get two whistles. Boogie says, the guys here playing poker think you and Randy need a glass of scotch and a cigar. Phil needs an apple juice, though, with a little tinfoil lid.
You know what?
Guys.
With those glass bottles of apple juice, those are refined.
They are good. Oh, I love those things. Yeah. Twittiant says, if Big George didn't send in his update last night, he must not have Wi-Fi. You know what? I think maybe he's just finally relaxing, but I was able to take care of it. Don't worry. We'll get that for you in a little bit. The Jet says, well, I know that 19 years ago was the biggest story for practice. Well, there's one thing. We'll get to it. Just relax. Good Cat says, Jeffrey, you made a joke earlier about $42 for my student loan to go to U Arizona. I'll have you know, it was $43 for my undergrad, but the rest was my grad degree from a college here in Phoenix. It was an ASU. So, let's see. Ooh,
thanks for the correction.
Roll Tide Kara says, hello, gentlemen. Happy Friday. Randy, can I get a Jack and Coke to numb my pain from surgery?
Hey, that reminds me, Randy.
Are you allowed to have alcohol right now?
Randy, why not? We never got the end of the show pina colada from yesterday.
Didn't need it. Shut up. Like Randy, we talked about this. He's not allowed to fire that off. He's not allowed to instigate that.
That's right. That's right.
Rewind it. Rewind it. No. Take it away.
No, we were owed a pina colada after yesterday's show. No. We never got to play it because of the end.
Sorry, if you guys are going to be on Boogie's side for the bet, you're going to have to respect that I got that out before the show was over. So
I was on your side.
Silly Wabbit says, and Phil would like to test King of Kittens bathroom by having a meal right there on his throne.
Oh, boy.
If it doesn't really speak to me and hit those oaky undertones while I eat on the unsaid toilet on said
oaky
crown,
undertones,
and I'm just out. I'm out. Remodel the whole thing over again.
Yeah.
Baker's Cocky Hen says, can we get a blind LeVar Burton instead of Aaron Rodgers? You know, he's not really blind. That was just a TV show called Star Trek.
No, that's a couple of Chicago quarterbacks.
Roll Tide Ryan says, Randy, you're cool, but us Charger fans have the same blind faith. Even when we had Breeze, Rivers, Gates, LaDainian Tomlinson. Sorry, buddy. It's not going to happen.
Did you call him LaDingling Tomlinson?
LaDainian. Fighting Wampa says, I keep hearing you guys talking about Phil and the word fire a lot, but you're telling me you pay him? You pay him for this kind of input?
I just kind of wander in day-to-day.
Only in America. Senior Wake and Bake says, hey, one for the road. Go Niners and shut the hell up, Phil.
Ooh, not just a shut up. Shut the hell up.
Patsy Lefty says Packers had the highest scoring tight end last year in Tanyan. But yeah, a major advantage for the Cards is on the defense. Skull says, you know, they're forcing Sharon Rogers out of the North. So the Vikings, that's right, baby, gonna win the Super Bowl. Packers didn't even win the Super Bowl last year. So what are you talking about? Jagdog says Rogers will break his tender, gentle old man bones there. And, you know, they don't make moon boots with cleats small enough for Kyler if he got traded to Green Bay. So, that'll never work.
Don't put that into the into the universe.
Ookla the Mock says, Oompa Loompa doopity doo. I got a riddle just for you. Arog and Phil does too. I don't get that. Arog? What? What is it? Why are you blowing a whistle?
That was just absolutely horrible.
It had nothing to do with anything.
Arog and Phil does too. What the hell does that mean?
And that's what I'm saying. Why are you blowing the whistle on that?
That's why the whistle. There's a yellow flag on that just for confusion.
So now that's what we're doing. We're blowing the whistle and throwing flags on confusion.
I'm the referee on the show here. That's right.
Your Angel Hernandez is showing, Randy.
Oh, there you go. There's one for you.
Hey, now I'm going to get a letter from Randy with a $250,000 fine because dared mention the officiating on the show.
That's right.
All right. Phil shows up in a Speedo, he only gets a $5,000 fine. Is that how that works?
A pat on the butt.
Yep. No. There's no pats on the butt.
Well, it's usually a pat on the hand, but if I'm wearing a Speedo, we know where the pats go.
I think we need a palate cleanser since Phil brought it up earlier. Let's talk a moment about the Olympics. Now, if you tune in the Olympics this summer, if there is an Olympics this summer, and if you tune in, it's a big if. you might actually get to watch some wild slip and slide action. Really? Not as an Olympic event. It's an after show thing. NBC has a reality competition in the pipeline called the Ultimate Slip and Slide. Okay. And they're premiering that right after the Olympic closing ceremony Sunday, August 8th. And it'll be hosted by, I like how they put, star. Bobby Moynihan from Saturday Night Live and Ron Funches, who's a voice of Cooper and Trolls, and he's a comedian, whatever. Anyway, the details are vague, but it sounds like they've created an entire water park of the giant slip and slides. And at least some, I don't understand, but yeah, they put together these slides. There's pieces there. NBC says one of those slip and slides is 65 feet tall. I guess teams will compete in challenges like the human bong. What?
Nice.
Body bowling, cornhole, and bocce fall.
As they should.
I don't know what any of that means.
Cornhole?
Ooh.
Cornhole, yes. But the human bong?
Yeah.
I don't understand that.
If it's smoking, the hell kind of come token.
This is NBC, for God's sakes.
Yeah.
So anyway, thank God, though, they didn't make that an actual event. But, yeah, as you also know, a lot of new Olympic events are not sports. And should never be considered that. I'm boycotting the Olympics. I ain't watching nothing. You guys can do whatever you want. I'm not watching.
Yeah, I don't generally watch the Olympics just because it's boring.
Hey, when we come back, maybe we'll actually talk about NFL quarterbacks. Hey. It's the Daily Blender here on 1580, The Fanatic.
Hi, this is Bruce Jacobs. My friends and former employers at ProCopy for over 20 years. ProCopy has provided Arizona companies with the best office equipment available from companies like Ricoh. More importantly, they provide outstanding service after the sale with a 96% retention ratio and award-winning technicians. 3 years ago, they joined the Flex Technologies Group, an Arizona-based nationwide group of companies that share ProCopy's commitment to excellence. So if you have branches anywhere in the United States or just here in Arizona, you can get great personalized service even during the current climate. We use them here at the Fanatic and Money Radio KFNN, and they never disappoint because they remain a local company. They give back to our community by supporting ASU and the Thunderbirds through the Phoenix Open. The ProCopy Foundations has raised hundreds of thousands of dollars that makes doing business with ProCopy good for your business. Just give them a call at 602-PROCOPY. That's 602-776-2679.
NASCAR Championship weekend returns to Phoenix Raceway November 5th through the 7th.
A wild season of unexpected will culminate in Phoenix with drivers putting it all on the line for their shot
at earning the title of NASCAR Cup Series champion.
Featuring four championship races in 3 days.
Don't miss your chance to witness history from atop the grandstands as the action goes five wide into the iconic dogleg.
Or from up close with access to the fan-friendly infield experience.
Get your tickets to see the NASCAR Championship in person.
Go to PhoenixRaceway.com.
Hurry, tickets won't last much longer.
Thank goodness it seems like the worst is over, but is your business back to pre-COVID numbers? Hi, Bruce Jacobs here to invite you to take advantage of a great opportunity to promote that you are open and ready to serve with our affordable Open for Business advertising package. You'll only spend hundreds but reach thousands of potential new customers. Just go to 1580thefanatic.com, click the link for the Open for Business package. This offer will not last long. The Open for Business package on 1580 The Fanatic. Now let's all get back to business.
Hey everybody, Mark Asher, back to tell you about my great friends over at the Lund Mortgage Team. Are you seeing what is going on in the home buying market right now? Unbelievable. Not enough inventory, and there is a ton of demand. Some of these homes are getting 30, 40, 50 offers on them. How are you going to stand out? How are you going to differentiate yourself from the other buyers who are in line? I have a way. Use the Lund Mortgage Team. Lund Mortgage Team is locally owned and operated with over 20 years of experience right here in the Valley. They have a great reputation and it is a trustworthy pre-approval. And on top of that, they are quick. That's one of the things. You got to come equipped and be ready to buy. So what you need to do is make that first phone call to 623-875-9940. That's 623-875-9940. Get that pre-approval going and then get yourself ready to go buy that home of your dreams. Go online, LundMortgageTeam.com, or call 623-875-9940.
The Fanatic. This copyrighted broadcast is presented by the authority of the Daily Blender and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form, and the accounts and descriptions of the show may not be disseminated without the express written consent of Jeffrey O'Brien's mom.
Hey, the Blender here on 1580, the Fanatic, Arizona's new home for sports. Well done, Just the Tip. He was the author of our Classic Rock Friday, the music. Yep, who knows? Yep. We'll have it next week. If you want to submit your six songs to be considered for Classic Rock Friday, by God, email them in to blender@1580thefanatic.com. We got a bunch of great lists in there, but there's always room for more. It might take a few weeks before you hear yours, but give it a shot. Send it in. blender@1580thefanatic.com. Six songs is all you need to send in, because that's how many times that we play return music here on the program. And you know what I'm going to do, Randy? I was thinking about this. Hey, remember last year when we did that 30-day song challenge and we made a playlist? It was on Spotify, made it available to everybody.
Yep.
One, I'm going to go through and clear out all the garbage songs that somebody who will remain unnamed put in. And two, I'm going to start to add in the songs that the super fans give us into the mix. And I bet with just one of the best kick-ass classic rock mixes you have ever heard on the Spotify.
Absolutely. Yeah, there you go. What happens when we add too many Pat Benatar songs?
You're
You will not touch it. Yeah, you're not even allowed to listen to it. You're not allowed to go near it. You ruin this. Kind of like in The Wedding Singer when Adam Sandler's like, take off that t-shirt before the band breaks up because of you. We don't want you anywhere near this.
So Jeffrey,
we'll start Phil's list. How's that? We'll start Phil's list, which would be another Spotify thing.
It'll be dripping with like Cher.
But that's fair.
And
to Phil.
Barry Manilow.
That's fine. That's
and
Phil's list.
Oh my God.
Her
you know,
Lola.
Oh my God. So, it'll be dripping with all of that stuff.
Barry Stewart.
All right, Phil,
Barry
you know Stewart. How to do this, right? Do you have a Spotify?
Yeah, sure.
Start Phil's list. Okay. And we'll give that link to you. There'll be the Daily Blender Classic Rock Collection. And then there will be Phil's list.
Yeah.
And we'll let people make their own minds up on stuff. And then they can listen to your list and give you some ideas. Because some people might like Phil's list. I'm going to be fair to Phil. I'm going to be P-H-A-R-E, fair to Phil.
because yeah, I know he'll put first. He'll put little fare in there. We know that. Yeah, it's absolutely happening.
Yeah.
So how's that? Does that improve your mood, Phil? I feel like Phil's been, felt like he's been picked on.
Maybe.
Yeah. No, I again, the entire day, everybody's just been wrong. So I'm finding that you're finally jumping
out. Shut the hell up, Phil. 888-368-1580. Let's get caught up on this text line. Senior Wake and Bake says, by the way, Famunda Phil, how about them Suns, son? Woo, keep on cheering for them Lakers. It's doing them well right there. King Kitten says, just the tips music did kick ass. And I'm going to dig deep into the rock, and I will present my list too.
There
send
you
it
go.
On over. Blender at 1580thefanatic.com.
May Hall & Oates never die.
Oh, that's another one. That'll be on Phil's list.
Yeah. Phil's list is going to soft
rock. Your kiss is on my night list.
Because your kiss. Yeah. Roll Tide Kara says, I vote for... I was trying. It's not just throw up a little bit in my mouth. That was what was coming out. She says, I vote for...
Wow.
Nickelback Mondays.
Oh. Roll Down Tide.
Whoa.
Multicara is trying to get blocked on the text line, I think.
Whoa. Look at this photograph.
I really don't.
Yeah. It doesn't happen here.
I got chunks in my teeth.
Yeah, better go brush your teeth, Jeffco.
Mystery Girl says, Phil, please include dance music for all us ladies.
Slow dance, up dance, we'll get it on.
I guarantee you, Mystery Girl, that you will not be turned on by his mix. But I bet the panty's going to drop when you hear the Daily Blender Classic Rock Collection. Ooh. Bam!
Yeah, oh yeah.
Or whatever you like. I'm not
sure.
Does that sound like sexual harassment?
It sounds like a good time.
I think it was close.
Yeah, I got to be careful there. My wife's not going to be happy. President Wallace panties? Says, did you just say fairy bill? Phil? What?
Fairy billed, and he thought that that's what you said when you were saying fair to Phil.
No, the fair to Phil. Colts fan Dan says, so Jeffrey, what do you think about the Colts draft class? I think that that my guy knows what he's doing. And as much as you might look at it and say, wow, that's a C, it probably will end up being an A. Because when Chris Ballard first started, everybody was kind of like scratching their head going, well, what the hell was that draft? But he always proves himself. So I'm going to hope it turns out well. And so should you, Colts fan Dan. Bruno Baller says, Phil seems like a Bee Gees Village People type of guy for his classic music.
Yeah, could be.
Probably going to have some of that in there. Yeah.
I do like Bee Gees.
See what I'm saying?
MCA.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And some of those songs I won't mind, but some I just have to. Yeah. I'll be hitting buttons like skip. And thank God I have a paid account for Spotify, because you can only skip so many times when it's not a paid account, and then you're stuck. Phil. Your microphone's on. Bruno Baller says, I already read that. Hefty Lefty says, Nickelback never days. How about that?
There we go.
I do agree. Mm. Baker's Cocky Him says, Randy, did you get my paper I left in your driveway this week? He says, at least Kara didn't say Creed, though. Yeah, I'd rather hear Creed than Nickelback. That's another poll question. Which song, which band would you ever rather hear? Ugh. Let's see. Papa Mike says, hey, by the way, why is Jeffrey still there? I heard him get 4 whistles in the past 30 minutes. How's he still on the show?
Well, we've had to relax the whistle resources. We've had to relax that just a little bit. Otherwise, Jeffrey
Radio Ron made him
pretty much every day. Yeah. So Radio Ron has relaxed the whistle guidelines.
Yeah, isn't it 6? 6 is
it's a lot of warnings.
Yeah. No, it's just never ending. Just whistle the hell out of them. But you can't ever kick him off the air.
Yeah.
You know what? Each time you get a whistle, Jeffrey, you should have to do a shot.
Nobody wants to leave Randy alone with Phil. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Nobody wants that.
No.
That's why.
Yeah.
Phil, don't forget the Osmond Brothers and Jackson 5, says Papa Mike.
Ooh, Jackson 5, yeah.
ABC. Actually, there are some songs on that aren't too bad, but yeah. You're right. King Kitten says, what happened to the Wheel of Sports and on this day? Well, I'll tell you what, I don't know if we'll get to the Wheel of Sports, but I can say this. It is time now for an epic on this day in Big George's sports history.
May 7th is a magical day in sports history. I have four magical stories for you. I will go as quickly as I can.
Okay.
May 7th, 1989, Michael Jordan hits the shot. May 7th, 1995, Reggie Miller took on the New York Knicks all by himself.
Okay.
And May 7th, 2002, Allen Iverson, talk about practice. And, of course, May 7th, 2016, Big Sexy goes to the yard.
Oh, yeah. 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 I remember those last two very, very well.
Yeah. All right. So do I need to explain any of these to anybody? Michael Jordan hits the shot, that signature moment for Michael Jordan.
No,
I was there. We're good.
You weren't even born yet. All right. How about when Reggie Miller took on the Knicks there after like 6 years of like ugliness?
No, I never. This one I'm not aware of.
All right. So it had been gaining steam for this game to happen. But the May 7th mojo returned in 1995 when Reggie Miller pulled off one of the most unlikely comebacks of all time, scoring 8 unanswered in 9 seconds down to the New York Knicks in game one of the Eastern Conference semifinals.
Yeah.
Sure, it was the Knicks, but clearly greater, more mysterious forces were at work there in that amazing 8 unanswered points from Reggie Miller in 9 seconds. That was a miracle. Okay, you know about the Allen Iverson and practice thing. We've all heard that clip.
We talk about practice. We're not talking about a game. We're talking about practice.
Which is the bigger deal? Was it Big Sexy going yard, or was it Michael Jordan and the shot?
Well, I think the entire world is going to go Michael Jordan the shot. But for me, Bartolo Colon, his first ever home run was a home run that was a game winner. Yeah. And they call him the Big Sexy because he's a shape. Round is a shape, the Big Sexy.
Yeah.
And he hit 1 yard and won the game. So,
yeah, he was 42 years old, about 4,000 pounds. And he just knocked that thing like crazy.
Yeah, he got all of it.
Yeah, that was a great time. That was a great, great, great moment. But yeah, Michael Jordan and that signature shot right there, trailing by one, facing elimination in the Bulls' first round series against the Cavs back in 89. Mm-hmm. He introduced himself. Hi, I'm Michael Jordan. And the rest is history. So there you go.
Sure is.
Back to me, Jeffrey.
What an epic wheel of sports, or what an epic on this day in Big Georgia sports history, Jeffrey.
Absolutely. Absolutely. The May 7th. Oh, to hell with May the 4th be with you.
Yeah.
And the May 7th is an epic day in sports history.
Agreed.
Baker's Cocky Hen says, Reggie Miller had the best 9 seconds of athleticism in history. Watching that live was just unbelievable. Senior Wake and Bake says, Randy with Murray isn't always fourth and short.
I think he's trying to say, is with Kyler Murray, aren't they always fourth and short?
It's a bad attempt, a bad execution. Yeah, you got to bring something better than that.
Things.
Yeah.
Bruno Baller says that Jordan shot was in game 5 against Cleveland that night. No, it was, I've already thrown the page down though. So I was talking, the game 1 was Reggie Miller's. President Wallet says, so what you want, but Nickelback knows how to write strong. Oh, say what you want. But Nickelback does know how to write songs for strip clubs.
Yeah, it was the Michael Jordan. The Michael Jordan shot was for Cleveland Cavaliers.
Yeah, that's what I said. I actually read that. That was part of what I said.
Yeah, and it was the final seconds of game 5.
Yeah.
I think I said that too. It was in the thing.
Yeah, I know. I was just helping you clarify.
Phil, do you listen to the show at all? When you're in there, are you listening at all?
I'm mostly trying to think of when's the next time I can dance on camera.
Well, we'll just take care of that right now.
Yeah.
as fast as I can. There you go, Phil.
Dance your heart out now.
Hefty Lefty explains the reason that I have not been thrown off the show for those technicals is because I am part of the host union that doesn't allow me to be kicked off. You know, like Angel Hernandez is part of the umpire union that doesn't allow him to be kicked off.
That's true, Hefty Lefty. You finally revealed the truth. You're live on radio.
Yes. Prison Wallet says, I had the best 9 seconds last night. Hello.
Hello.
Colts fan Dan says, best part about Reggie's heroics was watching him choke, do the choke thing at Spike Lee. Yeah, that's an iconic photo right there.
Yeah.
Baker's Cocky Hen says, with all the whistles, sounds like a Deshaun Watson massage going on in there. Oh, no, make grape wrestle jokes. No. Oh, my God. Cabana says, hey, we're going up to the rim tonight to try to see where the huge Chinese rocket's going to crash into Earth. It'll be spectacular if visible to Arizona. You really think so? Let's just hope that doesn't hit any populated areas. He says, yeah, you better keep your head up Sunday midnight because a huge rocket could crash down who knows where.
Oh, boy.
Hey, honey, let's sleep downstairs on
Sunday night. We're sleeping in the basement.
Yeah, we're going downstairs. I don't think a bet is right, but just in case. Bruno Baller says, happy Mother's Day out there to all you moms. Enjoy that race with your mom, Randy.
Yep, will do. My mom's dead, though.
Yeah,
come happy on, Mother's Bruno Day, Baller. Mom.
Oh, on Mother's Day, I get to go to my mom's gravesite.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
Guys. Jesus Christ. How many more minutes is left in the show? Mm.